And away we go for today's Sunday Funday shenanigans here again with Olaf the Undaunted, who's only died to logs and skeletons pretty much early on, and that was it. So we're going to see how he does this week, because it's time for boss number 4, apparently. That's the next logical step in our progression arc here, and he's been busy last week. He finished up doing the... he finished up harvesting silver, and it turns out I didn't need as much as I thought I was going to. I mean, he still needed a lot. Yeah, I managed to end up... I ended up farming, like, seven different deposits, and he still got, like, a lot of silver left. So I don't know what I'm going to do with all this silver. I'm not sure what he's doing with that. We went ahead and did his onion run, yeah, where we cycled onions back and forth, you know, onions to seeds to onions to seeds to onions to seeds. And then we were finally able to cook with the onions, and we made wolf kebabs, and we made, well, ice cream with the eyes and So he's using wolf skewers and ice cream, right? Better health and stamina. Still using turnip stew, right? 55 and 18. You're like, why are you still using this, dude? You need to be doing onion soup. I didn't do onion soup because onion soup, while it gives you 60 and 20 rather than 55 and 18, that's only 5 stamina and 2 health. But these only last 20 minutes, yeah? And the turnip stew lasts 25. So if the onion soup lasted 25, I would definitely be using it, but it takes a lot of onions to make it, and it doesn't last as long as the turnip stew. So I'm willing to trade 5 stamina and 2 health for 5 more minutes and synchronized buff expiration. Yes, that meant I had to grow a lot more turnips, so I had to do another cycle of turnips out there, and I've got seeds growing right now. I went ahead and got the wolf. Cape. I mean, it's got pretty much the same stats as the troll cape. It's just it protects you against cold, plus it looks suitably tribal. I've got a head sticking off my thing there. And now I know I need the silver, because you need the silver for the chain that holds it on. But here he is. We've got 52 armor. I've got 200 fire arrows. We've got did some building last week. Put my trophies up. I wanted to clear my trophy chest out, so I started mounting all the trophies. So we've got all the trophies, right? Everything from the neck and the boar and the deer, the rancid one I kind of cheesed. Garnet had one. I went and looked for one on him. I went smashing through a bunch of burial crypts to find a rancid. I found two rancids, but neither of them dropped a trophy, so I grabbed this from Garnet. She logged in, dropped it in his chest. And then you got the gray dwarfs, and you got the tongue there on the Draugr, the Draugr elite. You got the blob trophy that's dripping. You got the friggin' leech, which looks a lot bigger as a trophy than it does in the water. The abomination and this big crystal penis thing is the stone golem trophy. And then all the trophies from the mountains. The wolf, the drake, the cultist, the ulv, and the fenring, which is basically his arm. I guess I just tore his arm off and mounted it on the wall. This is fine, but it looks kind of weird. So that's all the trophies we've gotten so far. And I think that's how about all we've done with him. We finished maxing all his shit out. Maxed out his spear, maxed out the bow, maxed out the shield. And now we're ready to do Motor, who is way up here. So, you know, last week I went and built none of my little outpost bases here in the Black Forest, because there's nothing really, there wasn't anything really close to Motor already. Yeah, well, it's been 2 weeks, man, you know. I mean, really, the prep for the boss, man, is just gathering, harvesting resources, right? Upgrading your gear, upgrading your food, and then you're ready to go, because there's nothing else you can do. I mean, technically, I could upgrade my bow skill. I could sit there and farm a gray dwarf spawner or whatever. Welcome to the stream, sir. But it's been 2 weeks, right? Because we did bone mass 2 weeks ago, and then we prepped for the mountains. We introduced the mountains last week, and then I spent the time, you know, looking for all the... exploring all the mountain biomes I could get my hands on to find the shit that I needed to do, where I mined up, you know, hold on a second. I mined up a bunch of silver, explored a bunch of caves, upgraded his armor, and Groucho, how you doing, sir? Welcome to the stream. But that's all I did last week, was just farm silver and prowling out in the mountains looking for cultist caves and smashing wolves, because, oh my god, now I know why people friggin' breed wolves, because getting all the wolf hop pelts you need to upgrade your armor is just obnoxious. But you can do it by running around at night. You know, wait for Fenring to howl. He'll bring 3 wolves in. You can smash them. But we've explored, you know, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, seven different mountain chunks, and you know, we're done. That's pretty much all you need to do, right? Is upgrade your gear and get out there and kick motor's ass. So to that regard, I have got 200 fire arrows on me. We're going to see if that's enough. I don't know if it's going to be or not, but we're going to find out. So let's go ahead and we got the daytime. Let's go ahead and eat our food here and get our custom resting because I went in and built a dragon bed. Yeah. So now I'm up to comfort 12 here. And we'll chow his food here, which gives him 129 health and 191 stamina, which should be sufficient for our purposes today. Now, I have known nothing about the motor fight other than it's a dragon, and let's go ahead and remember to pick up the friggin' egg. Let's remember to bring our 200-pound friggin' item. Hopefully, we only need one because, goddamn, I can't carry two of them, dude. Get on my iron mace, and I will say, using Frostner, dude, going through burial crypts with Frostner is fucking hilarious, dude. I'm one-shotting everything in there. I'm like, two-star skeleton, whatever, smash, going on crunch. And it makes that boulder, that avalanche sound when it hits things. It's friggin' cool. Okay, so now we're gonna go to. I think I did. I'm about to wander in the VT of Valheim. No shit, man. This is like I said, I don't know. You have Frostrun, yeah. I have Frostrun, but I'm not using it for mountain stuff because everything in the mountains is resistant to frost, and half of Frostner's damage is frost. With the mace, it's all blunt. So. I'm better served using it in the thing. But I carry Frost everywhere else. When I go to the swamp, I had to get some ancient bark to upgrade his spear. So using Frost for that was really nice, man. I mean, one shot in draugrs, one shot in blobs. Found an abomination, and I was just like, okay, whatever. Lured him over a certling fire, just watched him evaporate. Like, okay. Uh-oh, wolf. What are you doing, wolf? You chasing the deer? Wow, that wolf fucked that deer up, didn't he? What's up, buddy? Bad doggy, no biscuit. Give me those, I'm gonna need the wolf. So you need the wolf meat for the skewers. Also need mushrooms for the skewers. Good thing I had those things stocked up. Use a lot of them. Okay, so let's see what we got. Having 191, I will say this. The whole time I've been playing this game, I've felt competent, capable, yeah? All through the swamp, all through the Black Forest, with his upgrades and gear and my relative lack of skill, I have felt competent, yeah, able to handle the stuff that I, you know, the challenges that are presented to me or whatever. When I got to the mountains, I started to feel powerful. I feel powerful now. Having all this stamina, dude, is just like, holy, oh, well a day. It says, sacrifice her spawn. The shrooms are the easiest. Yeah, it's just time consuming. You know, you just got to run around the forest. So here we are. We're going to look around at the tactical situation here, which is not terribly promising. We've got some cover behind this rock here. Meadows. Yeah, thank you. Glantry, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. On the other machine today, eh? Okay, so we're going to try and do motor here. Motor. I don't know how to pronounce it. Oh, do you have to bring three? Are you fucking kidding me? What? What do I have to do here? Do I have to... Okay, I don't know what I need to... Okay, so I gotta get more dragon eggs? Three eggs. There you go, Glantry. How you doing? Okay, so now we have a change of plan here. I have to go get more eggs. And it says offer sacrifice. What do I need to offer as a sacrifice once I get the eggs in there? It doesn't tell me. It just says sacrifice her spawn. Right. Okay. Oh, okay. So once I get the three eggs, I just activate it and it goes. Okay, well, shit. Now I gotta go back and... Gotta go back and get more eggs, man. This fucking sucks. Okay, well, damn. I could explore, I guess, but I'm not just gonna run around looking for fucking eggs. I don't wanna deal with that. Well, shit. Let's go back and get some more eggs then. Gonna be doing some running. You wanna flatten the ground? I got some maneuverability there. I'm doing pretty good with that, I'm doing pretty good with that particular thing. Oh, fuck off, dude. That fighting area didn't look too bad. I've got some flat area I can use, so I'm not too worried about it. As long as I got a place to hide, really. that's my biggest priority as low skill gamer. Where can I rest and recoup and heal and whatever? And no, I don't use the potions because I don't know how to. Oh, there's a mushroom. Well, grab that while we're here. Any more around? No. All right. Well, we're gonna be wasting some food. Now we gotta go back up to the other fucking mountains to get some goddamn eggs. Oh God, Jesus! I didn't think I needed 3 eggs. Fucking man, this is bullshit. All right, fine. We'll do it. Let's see where my other eggs are. Let's see if there's any that are close to my Okay, so the other eggs, I mean, there's 2 close here, and that's at 5, but I have to go across the water from Maine. Let's cross these out. Yeah. Let's cross these out. Let's cross out everything but the dots. Okay, I got 2 eggs here, but I have to cross the water to get to them. There's no eggs really close to 5. Relatively close to 10. I guess we could do that one. 10's pretty good. What else do I have here? Nothing by 1. These are too small to have eggs or anything else in them. And over here, at 15, yeah, no eggs over there. If we come down from 16, yeah, unfortunately 6 looks like my best bet, but it's across water. I don't want to do that. So we'll do 16. We'll go to 16. Okay, come on, let's go. Damn, I wish I would have known. I'd have done this last week, man. I'd have farmed these things out before. All right, let's go. 6 and south. We gotta go. Let's do the furthest one first. Okay, we gotta go this way. Alright, now we're just going to be doing some running, I guess. Oops, don't do that. Wrong game. Y is not jump, A is jump in this game. So let's go cruising, baby. Time to run up the fucking mountains. Whee! Well, at least I got a lot of stamina, and I'm running pretty quick with my new armor, so it shouldn't take too terribly long, I hope. Oh shit, I'm going to run out of stamina. Let's wait right here. Still got 18 minutes on my rested, so we're good there. Get up there, big guy. I don't know why stone golems are a pain in the ass. I don't know what their value is. Crystal's not that great. They need to drop something else that makes it worth killing them. Yeah. So all they drop is crystal and stone and maybe a trophy, and I'm like, oh, that's boring. Okay, that is the egg. Yeah, I hear you, you little shit. Whatever, dude. I need your glands, but first I need the egg. Oh man, I need the egg. Where's the egg? There it is. Whee! Grab the egg, and we are out. See you later, buddy. I had a really good moment last week when there was a, I saw a nest in the distance, right? But the drakes were just not, they hadn't aggroed me yet. So I crouched down and I got 3 shots, 3 kills, man. It was pretty fucking awesome. All right, what are we doing? We're going down here. That wolf just fell out of the sky, didn't he? Yeah, whatever, dude. I don't have time for your bullshit, man. You gonna follow me down? I will say that this is a fun game, but I would not recommend buying it until they fix the melee hitbox. Okay. When I swing my mace, it should connect to wherever my cursor is. I don't give a fuck if it's above or below me. It's ridiculous that the hitbox mechanics on melee is just so fucking jank. It's just terrible. It's the kind of basic, fundamental, day one kind of fix that should have been done a long time ago. So, I mean, people go, what's your biggest enemy? What's your biggest enemy in this game? The terrain. That's my fucking enemy. Elevation is my biggest enemy. Okay? The biggest, most fearsome enemy in the game is elevation. 100%. Okay. We got the far egg. And you really feel it in the mountains. It is so fucking annoying. Anytime something spawns, my first thought is, okay, where's a flat spot I can fight this fucker? Not, let me go kill this thing. It's so jank. It is so jank. It should not be that hard to fix. Yeah. Uh-oh. A pig just died. Was it a skeleton over there? Yeah, you guys go ahead and kill him over there, whatever. You keep yourselves busy. So, another snowy day in Vermont. Oh, well. Christopher building? Okay, so it's for the windows and shit. Are there other things you can make other than the windows? That's the only thing that unlocked when I got it. Come on, stamina. This pig is very confused. I don't need the meat, so just go down the mountain, bitch. Okay, up we go. Up we go. Back into the mountains for another egg run. Need to get some milk, too, and bread. Yeah, I hear you, Drake. I got time for your bullshit, homie. Jesus Christ, this mountain is, okay, up we go. God damn it. Da 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 da. Okay, we can get up this mountain. Having a high jump helps a lot. Running out of stamina sucks, and the Drake should get on the nuts, so I'm just gonna hide here for a second. Phoenix Denise, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. A snowstorm is coming. Yeah, we're in the mountains here in game too. Of course, it's the only snow I get to see. And look, a stone golem. Waste of my fucking time. I'm not even gonna talk to you, buddy. Now you go ahead and kiss my ass. You go fight that Drake. I'm done with you. I am so sick of those things, man. They're such a waste of my goddamn time. All right, let's go down here. Let's get off the top of this mountain. Take our eggs back. Look at that! Whiff! And now I'm below him and I can't hit him. I'm above him, I can't hit him. I'm below him, I can't hit him. Better sure don't stop him from hitting me. That, my friends, is janky bullshit. Janky bullshit. Okay. Let's get back with our egg. Yeah, we got it. We got the egg, right? Okay, good. We got the egg. Let's get out of here. Da-da-da. Another wolf. Where you at? Oh, I hit him. Look at that. Miracle of miracles. Come on, buddy. Okay. There's another one over there. That's a Drake. Okay. All right. Let's get out of the snow. Come down the mountain here. Jump a little bit. And jump a little bit. And jump a little bit. Jump a little bit. All right. Cool. Rock on, baby. Spent all goddamn day getting these eggs. Oh, let's go ahead and cross it off so I don't forget. Right, okay. Back to my little camp, and the sun's down, so I got to sleep. Oh, look at this. Let me mark this thing. Oh, whatever, dude. Please. Get off my nuts. Alright. Let's do that, and this, and that, and this, and that. Oh, I do have it marked. I turned off the marker. Alright. Back with our... The other night I punched a deer to death. I was laughing my ass off. I'm like... And I used to have to run around sniping these guys from stealth, and I just sprint up to them and beat them to death with my fists. I'm like, alright. Okay. Yeah, okay. So, let's get the other egg out. You are overburdened. I'm not overburdened? Oh, I put it away. Ha ha ha! Duh! Now I'm carrying too much. That's what I expected. Okay. Now we're gonna change this to 17. We're gonna go put these in the chest there, so I can run back and forth and stick them in the altar. Fictional animal abuse. Well, I mean, I used the meat and the hide. I mean, I wasn't just punching them up for entertainment, although it was entertaining. Okay, let's put you guys in there. Yeah, put you in there. Okay. Now we're gonna run up again. Whatever, dude. It's really hard not picking up carrot seeds and blueberries. I've been doing it for so long. Every time I see them, I'm like, ooh, blueberries. I'm like, dude, you have 500 of them. You don't need any more of those. Skill run 72. Da-da-da. Martin, how's it going? Welcome to the Fenring. Oh, one star wolf. Yes, he calls wolves when he bellows, but. Dude, I'm in an egg run. I don't have time for this bullshit. Get off my nuts. Alright. Oh, another wolf. Okay, good. 2 1-star wolves? Look at that. Well, it is nighttime. I don't have time for this bullshit. I'm on an egg run, you dipshits. Valheim looks really smooth. What kind of TV do I use? I have a Samsung. It's a Samsung. It's not an OLED or nothing like that. It's nothing expensive or fancy. It's an LCD and it's 75 inches? 75. Which was quite the task to set up by myself. I'm not going to lie. But it is really smooth. I've got it on performance mode and it gets a solid 60 all day long. In fact, is it this? Yeah, 60.1. I mean, literally 60.1 all day long. I get 60 frames a second all day long. Yeah, come on, you dumb fuck. Let's come on, man. Go ahead. Yeah, up yours. Also, the knockback in this game is silly, but we've gone over that before. Attach item. Okay. We've got 10 minutes on our buffs, huh? All right, let's go down here. Let's get the other fucking egg. Da, 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 da. But yeah, what you're seeing right here is the Xbox, is pure Xbox output. It goes from the Xbox to the capture card, which goes to my, you know, laptop. And then it goes from there to the TV. So the TV is the last stop. So you're probably seeing better output and performance on the stream than I get on my TV. Well, theoretically, it's the same because, I have the capture card hooked up all the time, so it's constantly going throughput to the TV from the capture card. Here I am clicking the left button to turn on my lights. I'm playing State of Decay all goddamn week, trying to get that last hat unlocked, and it will not unlock that last hat. Dude, you do not want any of this. Okay? You do not want this. That's why. Get off my nuts. They should be smart enough to run from you when you're a certain power level, I think. That'd be funny if they did. I put it in here. All right, last egg. Let's get it up there. Run back up. Whee! Running. True, how you doing? Welcome to the stream, sir. How is it going today? Even bigger TV. Dag, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. It's this TV that I've got now is about exactly the right size that it needs to be. If it were any bigger, I think I would get sick. Yeah, because it would fill too much of my vision. I wouldn't have enough around it, you know? The whole sitting too close to the TV so it looks bigger and shit, and I'm like, yeah, can't really do it. Noelle, how's it going? Welcome to the stream. How are you doing? We're running eggs to the altar so we can go back home, sleep, and then come back out with a rested... Woo, don't do that. Come back home with a rested bonus and fight this goddamn dragon. I wish I'd have known I needed 3 eggs. I probably should have checked this first, but I wanted the discovery to be on the stream. Okay, Mutter. Let's get up here and get this done, man. So when I put the 3rd egg in, I gotta be careful not to tap that center pillar thing. Alright, so we're gonna put that here. Alright, so when I do that, offer sacrifice, it'll be... That's pretty colorful, though. It looks pretty cool. A little splash of pink and purple and red in the middle of all this white and gray and black. I'm doing good, Noelle. I'm doing really good. The roofing saga continues, yes. We're going into our 3rd month of dealing with this, but I told him straight up, you know, the roof is intact. So speed is not, time is not of the essence. I will take my time and we will do this right. So the roofer sent the repairability test results to the insurer, to the claims adjuster, right? To show them, hey, we're going to need to replace this whole fucking roof, dude. We can't just take chunks of it and just patch it. We need to repair the entire thing. And they agreed. And they're going to pay for the entire thing. They're going to pay for the roof. They're going to pay for the solar panels to come off. They're going to pay for all that stuff. Yeah, one shot, one kill, youngster. Come on, you little dumb fuck. Stop waiting around in circles, you retard. So I got the updated estimate claim from them, and he called me. He said, hey, you want to cut your check? I'm all, not yet, not yet. We're still doing research. I still have to figure out how much the solar panels are going to cost. I didn't look and see that they put a line item for the solar panels, the removal and the replacement on there, and their estimate was $271. So I contacted my solar panel installers and said, hey, we're going to be doing removal reinstall for a roof repair. I need to get an estimate from you guys. So they sent it to me like a day later, $165 a panel, which is like half of what I thought it was going to cost. So me being the upstanding young citizen that I am, I emailed the estimate from the solar plant to them, because it was $3,000 less than what they were going to pay me. Only then did I realize, you know, I could have just cheesed it. Right? I could have totally just cheesed it and pocketed about $3,000, but I'm like, nah, I ain't doing that. Not that I'm like, you know, an upstanding young citizen and blah 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 blah, but I found over my lifetime that if you tell the truth, you don't have to remember anything. Yeah, you don't have to remember nothing. Because the truth is the truth. You don't have to make a special effort to remember something that isn't the truth. Plus, I'm just paranoid that they would probably find out somehow and come after me for that $3,000. So I'm like, nah, it's just easier just to tell them whatever the fuck. Because really, at the end of the day, the goal here is to get the roof replaced. I mean, I don't want to have to pay too much out of pocket for it. If I could do that, I'm going to call it a win. Yeah? So, people trying to take advantage of insurance. Oh, yeah, absolutely. I mean, given how most people feel about insurance, I don't completely blame them. But I don't want to be one of them. You know what I mean? And, If you're just above board and, you know, honest or whatever, it's like, you know, just makes life easier. It's like, here's the stuff, what's the next step? Here's the stuff, what's the next step? Here's the stuff, what's the next step? And you go from there, right? You go from there. Let me get one more of these out of here. Get the bonus food out from my fight here. Bonus food there, bonus food here. So what we're going to do then is on Tuesday, the roofing guy is going to come over, because the insurance claim has a bunch of math on it, and I'm not real good at math. Easy, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. I'm not real good at math, and there might be a way to get other stuff done on the roof, yeah, that's covered by the claim. And why am I hearing crunching? You fuckers are not, you are not fucking with my house. So we're going to talk about options like better shingles, better warranty, more durability, or maybe get an attic fan, or get gutters. I'd like to get gutters. That would be kind of nice. Yeah, it'd be nice to get gutters. And if I can swing it and get that tucked in the rest of the claim, that would be fantastic. Other than that, though, pretty good. Today is sort of a unique day in that... A year ago today, my previous companion went off to have new adventures. So today is kind of weird. It's been a year, you know. So here we are. Yeah. And it's difficult to explain to someone who doesn't have a long-term companion what that's like. Yeah. It's like, oh, it's just whatever. I'm like, dude. Okay, let's go get ourselves a fucking dragon. Let's go murder some shit. Full rested buff. Inflatable Brahmin. Haunted house only paint alive inside on the top. In case the zombie apocalypse happens while I'm sleeping. Jump 58. Oh god, it's fucking snowing so I can't even see. Great! Fantastic. Thank you, game. Thank you for making this fight even more of a pain in the ass than it's probably going to be. Alright, fine. God damn it, get up there, dude. So now I got a feeling it's gonna be flying around in the mist and clouds and won't be able to fucking see it. Fantastic. Fantastic. Alright. Yeah. It's a fucking blizzard, I can't see. Cool. Jim, how's it going? Welcome to the stream. Deal with updating my route about 3 months ago. Isn't being an adult awesome? It's not bad. It's just a lot of administrative work, yeah? I don't mind doing it. I just don't know. How do I put this? I don't have enough expertise in the subject area to know what I'm looking at and make authoritative decisions, yeah? I need to trust the people who are doing the work who I'm paying to give me good information. And while I have all the claim adjustment shit, and I have all the roof stuff, and I've got all the data in front of me, I don't know what the hell I'm looking at. So it becomes more challenging to deal with it. Am I going to wait for this to end? Fuck, I am. I am not sitting here. Fuck you guys. I am not going to fight her in a goddamn blizzard. This is ridiculous. Yeah? Fuck you guys. Take your goddamn bullshit and just kiss my whole ass with it. We're done. I'm going to log out and log in after that. Alright, now we wait. You think you did? You had to pick the colors. Yeah, I gotta pick the colors and I have to pick the options. Yeah. The problem is I don't know what the original colors were because I bought the house when it was 9 years old. And I have no idea what the original roof looked like. Okay. Environment clear. Fuck you. Ready to rock? Alright, here we go. Jesus Christ. Are you shitting me with this? Get out of here. Bad dog. Motors enraged. Okay. Oh god, she's big. Dude, look at that. Oh, these arrows don't do shit, dude. Oh, you just do Drake spitting? Is that really it? Oh god. Okay, this is a problem. This is going to limit my maneuverability. You get stuck, girl? Oh, she's on the ground? What? She lands? Whatever, dude. If you land, this is awesome. Okay, I can beat you up. Fuck yeah. Look at this. Dude. This rocks. Okay. So the mace... Oh, she's stuck. How does the spear do? Okay. Spear does better. Okay, this fight got a little less epic because, she's wedged. So I can just sit here and hammer with this spear. Of course, now I'm stuck. I can't get out. Okay, there she goes. Now she's flying again. Alright. That made it a little bit easier than it probably should have been, huh? Or she's really hard to miss, but I found a way. Terrain is my friend. Yeah, no shit, dude. I didn't expect her to just fucking get stuck. I mean, I'm not about taking it and using it for my own advantage, but... and she's gonna sit there. Yeah, she gets stuck. So maybe it's good I didn't flatten the land, huh? Look, she's just sitting there. I hear a stone golem, don't I? Oh no, that was the crystals breaking. Da da da. Okay, this is not... Yeah, I know you're pissed off. I would be too if I was getting ganked by the terrain, because I get ganked by the terrain. Okay, so this is poetic justice, my friends. All the time I spend fucking maneuvering around to get good terrain to be able to hit what I'm going for, and the enemy gets to feel my pain. Ha 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 ha. Up she goes. Yeah. But I'm back at full health, man. This is... I mean, this is the kind of fight that probably looks better on paper than it does in reality. Yeah, whatever. It is pretty cool, though. Okay, her landing animation needs a lot of work, dude. Her landing animation is the opposite of smooth and elegant. Of course, she's trying to land on another terrain. She should Scorch Beast Queen it and just not land. I would be okay with her not landing. Because this is... I mean... Misty's sitting waiting for her to figure out how to fly again. So in the meantime, let's just light her up. I got 200 arrows. Good way to skill a bow. I should have brought wood arrows, man. But yeah, just lighting her on fire, and she's just kind of sitting there. I'm sorry, Motor. I feel kind of bad for you now. Oh look, she gave me a little cave, a little chimney I can hide in. Uh-huh. Okay, this maybe don't spawn her temple, her sacrifice place. Maybe don't spawn her sacrifice thing in a place that isn't where she can't land. I mean, because this is, like, super fucking easy, man. I mean, I'm on very easy. Yeah, okay, I get it. Yeah, blah, blah, blah. It's going to be easy because it's easy because I'm... But... Let's go to a place where she can land. Can you land? She is down the ground. Okay. Knock down a whole fucking tree. Jeez, I should have bought stamina potions, man. If I'd have known she's gonna be this easy. Taking a long time though, because I had to wait for my stamina to come back. Chopping down a fucking tree, dude. Okay, I gotta time her thing block better. I'm immune to frost, girl. Motor's in tears. Yeah, she's probably crying about the shitty landscape code, too, huh? God knows I would be. This up, dragon tear. Oh, that's what the tears reference was. All right. Now, see if these guys would have been around during the fight, it might have been a little more epic. Time to go to the meadows of the end game. There you go. Right. I did not expect her to be that easy, man. She needs a lot of work, man. A lot of work to make her more make her more, I don't know, challenging? Since she can't land, all you gotta do is pepper with arrows and avoid the ice crystals. It's not difficult at all. And, I don't know, man. I'm going to cut this wood up. God knows I'm going to need wood, so might as well get it while I'm here. Okay, so there's the motor fight. Landscape jankery, and, her glitch is bad for my motivation. Yeah, something like that. So yeah, there's the motor fight. Definitely they need to rework the placement of her altar and give her plenty of flat areas to land on if she wants to land. Cause if she gets stuck in the terrain, man, it's just like, well, okay. I don't know. It should have been a lot more epic than it was. But it was just basically taking advantage of janky physics and rough animations. And, yeah, it, I don't know. I'm glad I beat her. Now I can go do the exploration that I like to do the best, but strangely unsatisfying to do it, man. It's like, I feel sorry for her. It's like, man, I'm sorry. I'm sorry your bounding boxes are too big for you to manage the terrain that they stuck you in. Oh, God. I still got 7 minutes on my bus, for God's sakes. Should be live streamed. Yeah, no shit. I'm on Team Easy on this one. I vote with Easy. I stand with Easy. That sounds weird. Yeah, let's just drop the rocks off back here because I don't need those for damn sure. Drop the rocks. The last frozen. Why do I have 10 of them? That is peculiar. Probably gonna need to farm her for something. Well, Icathir was a cakewalk. Elder was a slog. Bone mass was kind of terrifying. And motor was kind of like, okay, we did it. Congratulations, go us. But I don't know, man. I just feel bad for her. It's like, I'm sorry that you couldn't fight. But they didn't see fit to give you the ability to do so. All right, put that in there. Let's put the tears in the trophy box. I'll remember where those are. And then put the seed in there. Put the obsidian. I don't know where the hell that came from. No, the obsidian goes with the friggin' feathers. That's right, because I used to make arrows. Goes in there. The wool stuff goes down in here. And then the resin goes here. Alright, time to go turn this shit in. Oh, let's put the arrows away too. I'll probably kill her again just to get the trophy to hang up on the wall here. But God, that was sad, man. Oh, okay. What are we doing? We need to go to O2. Is it O2? Yeah, it's O2. O2. Game Town Walkthrough, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. Alright, we're gonna go hang this head up. Let's go put this head up. With 11 minutes left on my food and 18... Well, I just went into my house. Okay, let's put her head up here. Let's see what her trophy looks like. We know what bone masses look like. Here you are. Oh, that looks fucking cool, dude. Always tailwind when sailing. Ooh, I'm gonna like that one later. Not big, Always a tailwind when sailing. Ooh, man, when I start going on the boat, I'm gonna like that power. For now, though, I'm gonna stick with my running one. Because I run away a lot, yes? So there we go. Now we got four bosses up there. Looking pretty cool. This is a really cool trophy, man. That is a really cool trophy. I'm just gonna look at it a little bit more, yeah? Got horns and spikes and shit everywhere, man. That shit's rowdy. Alright. So let's go repair our gear. Explosively blew their nose. Yeah, it's the Bone Mass trophy is disturbing. But Motors is cool. I mean, I feel bad that I cheesed her without even having to cheese her. She cheesed herself, man. You know? Used her eggs and she cheesed herself, so I omeleted her. She was omeleted. Pretty bad. Okay. So fix our gear, very important. Muy importante, fix our gear. Now what we're gonna do is we're gonna put the mace here. Grab Frostner. Oh yeah, look at that beatdown stick right there, baby. That's what's up. Alright, now we're ready for the planes, yeah? Silver shield, big old bone crushing mace. And her head'll fit pretty good on one of these lower ones, I think. So that won't be so bad. But yeah, there's bone mass right there. It's pretty disgusting. Insufficient coating. Yeah, and I know, Groucho, I get it. It's just, it's a boss, man. You know? I mean, if you're gonna fuck up the regular wolves and the regular stone golems and shit, make that crap janky, that's fine. But I mean, it's a boss fight, man. It if nothing else works correctly, the boss fight should. You know? And it's just like, I don't know, man. It's the first boss I've killed where I feel bad for her. Yeah? It's like, I'm like, oh look, I can cheese you. Okay, I don't even have to work at it. Okay, cool. Alright. So let's see what we've got here. Let's take all the markers off, except for our things. And let's see where the plains are. So we got swamp down here on that mountain. We've got a little strip of plains right here by 15, but there's mostly swamp there. We got a little nugget of plain. No, that's not even plains. That's Black Forest. We've got some plains up here, but again, it's a pretty small strip. We got this here, which looks fairly extensive, but I can't tell how far it might go out. And there's this little nugget right here. Anybody's guess how much plains we got there? Nothing over there. This is plains. There's plains hidden in here by number 12. But oddly, there's meadows down here. What was that one? Okay, once that cloud thing clears up, unless that's just plains, but that's a really rough transition. But we got plains here and there's mountain here. So it looks like the plains might go around the mountain. That might be a good place to start. 12 might be a good place to start. What else we got? That's it, pretty much, for the easy plains, anyways. Looks like there's a little nugget over here. No, it's a swamp. So yeah, it's plains up here by 17. We got a bunch here, there's a little bit over here, there's a little bit over there. The boss one wins. Yeah, those boss fights suck. And see, the thing is for me, the boss fights for me are not that important, right? Because I play this game to explore. I like just running around exploring things. I mean, look at all this, man. I only had to take a boat twice or three times. Once there, across this. Once here, to cross that. Once here, to cross that. After that, we're gonna have to branch out and see how much more. This really is weird, though, that it's got this ocean. We got this whole wide thing running down here into the thing there. Okay, so there we go. The clouds cleared up. So that's plains and that's plains. So it looks like 12 is going to be our best bet. Let's go for 12. Yeah. We're going to go for 12 and we're going to sleep. Now we're going to wander around and look at shit and probably try not to die. The good thing is I know I can take Deskitos with bronze gear, so if I've got mountain gear, I should be fine. And I do have cloud berries. I did grab some already, but I don't know what they're... I mean, I'm sure they're for cooking. But, good morning. Good morning. Good morning indeed. Okay, what we're going to do here real quick is I'm going to log out. I'm going to log back in because I don't know how to reset the environment with dev commands. Yeah. So I'm just going to log in back in. That'll clear the dev command. That'll reset the environment to standard. We'll get back in here and do this. Little man's eating his crunchies. Patrol cat. Doesn't look for onion seeds. Yeah, I don't know what I need to look for out here. I know it's, what, barley or flax or wheat or... I mean, I know you get to make bread at some point, I think. Maybe find out what the tetras are for. Because I did find another cave that had tetras in it. So now I have three of them. What we're going to do is we're going to take the cloud berries out. We're going to put those in here because I'm sure those are used for something in the plains as well. I know the tetras are important, but I don't know why. Yeah. You make something with tetras, I guess. That's fairly useful. Okay. So we're going to sit here for a minute and we're going to get our rested bonus. And we're going to look around the plains. Let's see if we can find that out here. Now, is this my spawn spot? Yeah, because I slept on it. Baking bread sounds fun. It's... when it comes to games like this, survival games, the more intricate the crafting mechanics get, the weirder it gets for me. The more difficult it is for me to remember things. Yeah. Okay, so we're going to open the chest. No. Artisan table. Okay. So that's probably from the tears, right? I'm guessing. Put some wood in there, right? And then always put the restock the resin on the standing torches so I know when I come back at night where the goddamn door is. Some buns in the oven. Yeah, like I said, I don't know. I don't know what I'm gonna be finding out here. So here we are. Yeah, here we are. And our planes are up this way. So let's just get going. Oop, don't go in there. There we go. These things are great for if you're a starting builder. These stone rings are awesome because you can put your fences around between the rocks. And it's a pretty flat area to build on. Okay, so here's the plains. I do not fear Deskitos. But I don't know. See, the thing is, you gotta listen for... Oh, there's some fuelings. Okay. I see you, you little shit. I don't have to worry about your fire, you little fucker. The spear throwers, though. The spear throwers are apparently quite scary. Oh, there's Deskito. I see you. I saw you, little shit. Come on. Uh-oh. Are you cackling, little goblin? Come on, man. Oh, I see it. Come on. You want it? Come on. Yeah, motherfucker. Okay. Well-a-day. Black metal scrap. Okay, so you don't have to mine... but you had to murder these little motherfuckers. Okay, that's fine. Oh, look, it's raining. The Fenris armor. I'm a huge fan of nullifying. Plus, I blocked the first thing him he swung at me. Oh, he's swimming with the torch in his hand and the torch doesn't go out. Are you serious, guys? Come on. Come on. But see, look at this. I'm angling for flat ground, right? I'm like, I'm not going to fight him on a hill. I can't fight him on a hill. Come on out, dude. Come on out where it's flat. With your burning torch in the water. Yeah, huh? Come on. Oh, he's got Grey Dwarf AI. He's gonna run around in circles for a while. Alright, so black metal, so hunting these guys is gonna be what I'm doing here. Okay. Alright. Stone, I don't need stone. I'm kind of listening for Deskitas because I still got PTSD from getting my ass kicked by them back in the day. Now I'm listening. Oh, that's a bird. Okay. My Greek fire. Yeah, fucking Fuelie's got napalm. That's all I need. Yeah, that's all I need. So now we're going on the plains, and I'm looking for things that I don't. Because again, right, every time I go to a new biome, I don't know what's significant. I know what cloudberries look like. Yeah, and they tend to spawn in these little patches of these little red field. Here they are right here. Yeah. Boy, there's a lot of them here, man. Do they all spawn in clumps like this? That makes me nervous. Now here you cackling, you little son of a... Man, come on, you little son of a bitch. Where are you at? And then there's locks. These big old... I don't want to mess with those guys. They're probably peaceful. So if I don't attack them, they'll leave me alone. I'm hoping. I'm guessing if I get too close, they'll get sassy. Oh. No. You're fine, big fella. No. We're cool, dude. Okay, the question is, can you climb rocks? Yikes. Yeah, you definitely can. Oh my god, how much health does this motherfucker have? Pierce, maybe? Jesus Christ. Okay, Pierce is better. Okay, Froster doesn't work on him, but that sure did. Locke's pelt. Locke's pelt, Locke's cape, Locke's meat. Okay. That actually never happened to you, where he attacked you? Yep, there's that AI again. Just run around, buddy. Run around in circles, dude. Just go ahead and run around in circles. Don't bother attacking. Hell, a spear does for him, too. They're so difficult. Fueling trophy. Is it fueling or fulling? I don't know. So how do you feed a lox? Do you have to walk up to it with your weapon not out? I hear it. There it is. I see him. I see you, fucker. Dude, why are you so aggro on me? Got a lot of knockback. Blocked, motherfucker! Okay, blocking definitely does a good job on them. So for anybody who's experienced at Valheim, who's watching the stream, I'm going to remind you all, I play on very easy. You're like, holy shit, dude, what are you using? I'm using the same gear you are. I'm just playing on a difficulty that's 3 levels lower than yours. You got to trap them. Okay, so it's you get them to follow you, and then you put them in a pen. Okay. Well, I ain't doing that. I don't find that aspect of gameplay compelling. Yeah. But yeah, spear works really good on them, and then Frostern for everything else. Frostern didn't work for shit on them. See, the thing is, right? The people who do the farming and stuff generally need a lot more material because they play with other people. Yeah. I play by myself, and I don't mind running around for hours farming shit. You know, that's fun to me. So. For a lot of people who don't like, who are very, you know, more achievement oriented, goal oriented, wandering around a biome for an hour and a half just looking for meat is not something they're going to find entertaining. I do. I'm just like, this is kind of fun. It's relaxing, yeah? Looking for the supplies I need to survive. Okay, let's listen to music. Yeah, the music's still bang on 100%. It absolutely suits the feel. Yeah. Whoever did the music for this game, man, you need to pay him more. Because they nailed the mood of every fucking biome so far. Freedom Man, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. Add a $5 tier. Thank you very much for the donation. You can adjust that level anything you want to, dude. The minimum is $1, but you can put however much you want in there. Back in the day, there were some people that were putting like lots and lots of... Because it charges per month, yeah? So, but you can put any amount you want. I just put it there as the minimum so, you know, people could participate and not feel like they had to do whatever. I'm not entirely sure how it works because whatever, but... But yeah, as I understand it... Okay, what's this? Yeah, that fucking music is perfect. Their composer, whoever did the music for this game, whoever's, if it's more than one, y'all did a bang up friggin' job. I mean, normally you know me, guys. Survival games, first thing I do, turn the music off. Yeah. This music in this game is perfect. It's perfect, perfect, perfect. Tia Tia, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. We're in a new biome. We're in the plains now. We beat Mother. Which was kind of a sad fight. It definitely needs a little bit more work. Because, I mean, if she gets stuck, man, she's just like, okay, well, good. Now it's like, you know, a pig in a poke. You're like, I'm done. Let's pick some more cloud berries. So artisan table, I'm going to have to figure out what that is when I get back. And the Locke's cape. And what I can make with Locke's meat, because, of course, I have to use the cauldron for it to tell me my new recipes. Is there any? I can't see because it's raining. That's fine. Landscape and lighting. Yeah, I'm a huge fan of it myself. And yeah, about the low skills. I saw the comment before it flipped by. Yeah, when you get older, man, you cannot do that. Those abilities that you once had have been deprecated. Now you are operating under a more limited set of functionality. And you're just going to have to deal with it because you can't make it any better. I mean, sure, I guess I could just take meth or something and get all cracked out and shit. But my hands still don't work. So it's like, I gotta be judicious about my difficulty. But with that said, I'm also not trying to... I'm aware that people who have skills are watching this, yeah? Or maybe watching this. And I don't want them to think that I think that I'm a badass... Because I can just, you know, carve my way through this fucking game. And well, no, guys, that's the only way I can play this, okay? But, it that said, my entertainment, my sense of satisfaction of conquering a challenge doesn't revolve around the bosses. Yeah. 1 star, huh? Come on, man. Do it again, dude. Try that again, bitch. Come on. Nope, wander around circles. Yeah, fuck. Fuck you, dude. I will say the knockback in this game is silly. The amount of knockback in this game is silly. It's like playing fucking Street Fighter. I'm like... Come on. 2 1-star fuelies? What the hell is this, dude? Is it nighttime? You hit me, I hit you. Fair is fair. How am I doing on weight? Black metal is only 10 pounds apiece. Okay. A heavy pelt of thick, musty fur. A twisted hunk of dark metal. A raw slab of marbled meat. The pointy end of a desquito. Okay. Alright. I haven't seen a village yet. Oh, God. This is almost nothing. We're almost at the other end of it already. Well, that kind of sucked. Okay, so we're going to need to probably build a boat here. Huh? Find a place with more planes. Okay, there's 3 of them. question is, are they pack animals? I don't think they are. Oh, that's a house over there. And I've got something marked over there. Oh, that's right. That's that. If it ever clears up, I'll show you. If you look over there, right above my head, right there. It's a big shiny rock. Oh, that's plains over there. Oh. Well, hell. That worked out nicely. So this house then is going to be the studio small enough. I'm sure somebody has in the last 3 years. It's not the fact that it's inconsistent, Freedom Man. It's the fact that it's so much. Yeah. It's like, you're bouncing all over the map like you're playing fucking Rocket League, and I'm like, okay, what have I got? I got those arrows. I see that Deskito over there, too. I am sensitive to those motherfuckers. So if I piss off one of these locks, will all three of them come running? I guess there's only one way to find out. Here, pal. He's big as a fucking house, man. He's really hard to miss. I missed him anyway, though. Okay. Yeah, eat it. Okay. Again, for the people who are watching at home, for the people who with skills who are watching this later, I am under no illusion that I am fucking awesome at this game. That I can just sit there and murder a lox and get hit once. It's like, okay, whatever. There we go. That's not why I play. Oh, but see what I mean about the knockback? Dude, if you hit a person that hard, you're gonna turn their internal organs to paste, dude. Okay? It's just goofy. It's laughable, you know? And when you start laughing at a game, not out of entertainment and pleasure, but out of mockery, that game doesn't have a very long shelf life anymore. Marty, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. To catch you up, we beat the boss. We beat Mutter. It was a very janky boss fight. I'm not very happy with it. It was not very impressive or entertaining. It was kind of sad, to be honest with you. And Lox ain't taking no shit from no prayer door. I tell you. But look at that, dude. He knocked me back 30 feet. Do you know how much force it takes to knock a human body back 30 feet? Oh my god, dude. It's so stupid. Alright, let me get my Lox meat and my hides. I'm sure there's a trophy. They drop a trophy at some point, too, I'm sure. Lack of skills. Yeah. It is what it is, man. It is what it is. But yeah, okay, so we can kill Lox. Good. I don't have to worry about them bushwhacking me at least too much. So we have a house right here on the edge of the... I heard you, fucker. Come back here. I see you. Come on. Come on. Come on in, dude. Blocked. Dead. That's right. Eat it. But see, we got a house. Oh, where's that? We got a house right here, but the waves are a little aggressive. The waves are a little aggressive. What's in here? Oh, it's a two house. Randomized algorithm. No, they do. It does have its own physics. Okay. The amount of knockback for the attacks is consistent. Yeah. It's not like it just rolls a dice as how far is he going to fly in this guy. But it's just the amount of it is excessive. The amount, the distance you go back is excessive. And, yeah, okay, full belly, full sail. So our nearest house is at 13 here. I'm going to go back down, I think. I'm going to go back down here and we're going to uncover the rest of this. Eat it. Okay. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go back down. I want to explore the rest of this, right? I want to uncover the fog of war and the rest of this little. Might as well pick it up. Is that a trophy that I just picked up? No. Okay, good. We're gonna go back home in the dark because who cares? Meadows up here, but plains down there. And see, here's the plains. And again, the biome blending is fucking amazing. The music's amazing. The biome blending is amazing. The amount of interesting points of interest. Yeah, the amount of distribution points of interest is really good. Where it fails is basic fundamental things. Knockback, the amount of knockback. I don't mind a little bit of knockback, you know, half a foot, but when you get knocked back like 10 yards, dude, you're like, okay, that's ludicrous. It's like, what the fuck, man? And yeah, this is a very small splice. Okay, so we're gonna have to definitely go across there to get some real planes action going and figure out where to build ourselves a house. It looks like there's plenty of wood and okay, you're a spear thrower. All right, come on, do it to it, dude. No, run around in circles first. Come on, there we go. I like spears, by the way. I'd like them a lot more if they could actually hit you below your knees. Okay, there's some more locks over there. I know now they're not pack animals, so if I pull one of them, the other one won't come. Yeah, we'll leave them alone for now. I just want to get the rest of this uncovered so we can go back home. Yeah, this is a pretty small chunk of plains, but it's a good introduction. Oh shit, that's knockback. Look at that shit, dude. He knocked me back, what, 20 feet? It's like, yeah, dude, I'm sure. You don't have any muscles or sinew, but you can knock me back 20 feet. It's like, Goblins like to hit you from behind. The thing about it is, it's just their regular AI. All the gray dwarfs do it. Every enemy who doesn't attack directly does it. Every gray dwarf does it. The friggin' the draugr don't do it. Skeletons don't do it. But everything likes to run around in circles before it attacks you. And it's just like, oh, look, Deskia trophy. All right, cool. But it's just the combat AI. It's just funky, and I don't know why. Yeah? Come on. I see you, dude. Circle, 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 circle. Yeah? Circle, circle, circle. Knocked back off a cliff or in the water problem? It is, yeah. The water's the worst, right? Because if it gets between you and the shore, it will knock you back 30 feet in the water every time. We had that when we were in the swamp, and it's just like, you'll literally drown trying to get back to shore, because anytime anything touches you, flicks you with a finger, you go back 20 feet. It's like, okay, well, I'm drowning trying to get out of the water. I can't get out of the water. Of course, you can use it to your advantage. If you're in the water and it gets behind you, well, you just have it knock you into the fucking next zip code, and you're like, okay, cool. But the knockback mechanics are just, like I said, they're just jank. It's not, they're ludicrous, yeah? They are noticeably bizarre. I mean, if I want to play Street Fighter, dude, I'll play Street Fighter, okay? I hear skeletons. Come on, big fella. Get that first block in, and he's done for. Do these guys have trophies? They probably do. Something dying up there. Let's go help him out. So yeah, it's just... Man, they are whipping the shit out of that Great War Brute. Okay, where did you guys come from? Where did you guys come from? We're not doing that, dude. We're just not doing that. Okay, skeletons have to come from somewhere. What am I carrying that I don't want? Yeah, we'll get rid of the wooden stone because I can get that shit anywhere. I don't need butte berries. Look, man, do you see the corpses of your friends? Get the fuck out of here. Okay, where did those skeletons come from? They came from down here? Yeah, there's more destruction up here. Oh, a needle! Look at this, a Deskito came up in here. So we had skeletons, Deskitos, Praetors. I need your eyes, though. Okay. Skeletons always come from somewhere. Where did those skeletons come from? A tower? The problem with skeletons, they can run a long way, man. But yeah, knock back off a cliff, too. Definitely another one of those why the terrain is your enemy kind of things, right? If you knocked off a cliff, dude, you'll die from the fall damage. And that's kind of a problem, yeah? And there's no skill that prevents it, yeah? Like, if you improve your block skill, it doesn't reduce the amount of your knockback. At least I don't think it does. Damage absorbed when blocking with a weapon or shield. That's it, just damage absorbed. Excuse me, dear. I'm looking for that skeleton. Where the fuck do those skeletons come from, man? There's nothing here. You want to get salty? But see, like this shit, right? I actually hit him. What the hell? That was interesting. When you're surprised when you hit him, it's like, that's a problem. But I mean, it's really good. Frame rate's smooth, doesn't crash. It's just, it's very stable. The motif is great. I mean, it's awesome. It's just the things that are janky with it are so fundamental that you'll run into them all the time. And after a while, are you not going to knock back enemies? No, you cannot. You can stagger them. Yes, you can stagger them. They will stop attacking you and be vulnerable to your next attack. But if I hit an enemy, it won't knock him back 30 feet, no. If I block them, it will. Sometimes it will. Like if I block a wolf, he'll fly back 10 feet. And I'm like, okay. So what happens is, you block him, it knocks him back, right? And the amount of time that he's staggered is how long it takes you to catch up to him to hit him again. So you literally don't even get the benefit of your parry bonus. You can't use it because he's out of your range. What are you gonna do, throw a fucking spear at him? Sure. I heard you, little fucker. Come on. Eat it. There we go. Look at that. Can't even hit him. Why? He's 6 inches below me. I've only got a 6-foot fucking spear. You'll see when you block. There you go. Look at that. I can't hit him, dude. Look at this. I mean, seriously. The whole point of having a spear is it extends your reach, both up, down, and forward. And yet he's in front of me and 6 inches below me, and I whiff over his head every time. Because you see, it makes a lot of sense if you realize, once you realize, that your character has a piece of gear that you don't get to see or unequip. And that's a back brace. He has a back brace. He can't bend, he can't squat, he can't reach down, he can't do anything like that. He's very stiff and he's very vertical. Once you realize that, then everything starts to make a whole lot more sense. We call him Rust the Truss. That's what he's got, yeah? So yeah, that's the deal. Okay, let's go back to our base. And let's see what we can make with this new ship we got. And then figure out how we're going to get across the water at, what was it, 12? Yeah, 12? No, 13's where I want to go. 13 is closest to the place I want to go. So we're going to put away the resin in here. Let's just throw some crap behind the fucking bows because I'm not going to need it. I don't need bones for damn sure. Don't need bones. Don't need the seed. Okay. Kept going over his head. Yeah, that's... You're not incorrect. parting his hair. Yeah, doing a hell of a job parting his hair. Piercing his ears for him. Give him some earrings and shit. I don't know. Okay, so in here, we're going to put our new trophies. We got trophy here and trophy here. Okay, now to put some shit away. Oh, the skull, right? I've still got 20 skulls, right? Yeah, let's dump the skull. Let's dump the skull over here in a pile. And put everything else away, right? Oh, it's a rainbow of trophies. I actually got around to doing my taxes last week. I'm very excited about that. I kept forgetting. Because I try to make it to where I don't... I'm trying to make it to where I don't have to... Where I don't get money back and where I have to pay a little bit. Yeah. Try and maneuver it that way. Okay. So we're going to put... We're going to put this in there. And then we're going to put the scraps in here. And then in here's the trolls, and there's the bones, and here's the wolf shit. And then there's my seeds. So then we're going to put the locks above the wolf stuff. And the needles, don't take the needles out. Put the needles in there too. I have to keep everything from a biome in the same area. Okay, we got that. We'll put the eyes away. Put the gold in here. Right, yeah, put the gold in there for later. I'm gonna put these over here. Don't really need those anymore. Okay. I'm gonna put away the boar meat and the... Is it in here? It's in there. Okay, so now I got 100 of those, good. The cloud berries are here. All right, so the cauldron, if I use the cauldron, I get nothing. Okay, so... let's see what we have. I don't think it's fed any extra money. Me either. Me either. Normally, every year, I usually pay about... anywhere between $10 and $100. This year, however, I got a refund because I hadn't realized the standard deduction went up by like $1,300. So, yeah. So we're gonna have to do some adjustments in my income, in my deductions. All right, artisan table. Where is the artisan table and what is it for? Let's get the hammer out and see what we need. Locks rug, okay, fair. All right. Artisan table sounds like crafting. Butcher's table adds. Okay, I don't see anything new in here. Spice rack, butcher's table, workbench, chopping block, tanning rack, tool shelf, artisan table. It is a crafting station and it uses dragon tears. But it only uses regular wood. Okay, what the hell is this for? Let's get some regular wood and two dragon tears and see what we can make with it. And decide where we're gonna friggin' put it, because I got no room in my house for anything else. But... So dragon tears are in here. We need two of these. Okay. Where am I gonna put this fucking thing? Stream my taxes next week. Oh no, 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 no. There will be none of that. Way too much PII in that one. So where the hell am I gonna put this? I'm gonna have to expand my base again, aren't I? Let's see, if I kick the wall out this way, how much work do I have? How much work would I have to do? Quite a bit, because that's a hill. If I went the other way, if I went out this way and kicked the wall back out here, I'd have to move all the chests, and that would suck. And if I kicked this wall out, I'd have to deal with all the goddamn artisan tables and shit. So I'm going to have to just pickaxe this shit, build back out this way, and then move the... move the charcoal kiln and the smelter over. language you use. It's just mostly size, because it's like the thing about the taxes is it's so complicated. It's like it shouldn't have to be this hard. I got a hobby where I make a little pittance of income. I got my main job, and I got maybe a little bit of interest in investment income, and that's it. It should be a matter of like 20 minutes. But I gotta go schedule E and schedule C and all this shit. I'm all, does that even apply to me? I don't even know. I can't figure it out, you know? Have to hire somebody to translate the shit for me, and I'm like, I don't have money for that. If I had money for that, I wouldn't need to be doing this. So, let's just drop it in the middle of the goddamn field for now and see what happens. Hopefully it doesn't have to be covered to be used. Yeah. Well, look at this. It's all got gears and shit. Wooden missile, stone oven, blast furnace, spinning wheel, and windmill. Crafting station needs a roof. Of course it does. Okay, what we're gonna do, I'm gonna break it down. So now I know I need a roof for this fucking thing, and I know it needs to build other things with it. So let's see what else we can build with it. Okay, we got spinning wheel, which you would need to make thread. Or cloth, a windmill, this requires the artisan table, what, mills grain, I guess, right, so a mill. And then in here, we don't have anything new in here. Here's the crystal. We have nothing new in here. And then in here, nothing really new in here either. Well, Locke's rug is here. Yeah, Locke's rug is there. We got a hanging brazier, a blue standing brazier, torches, banners. The list of bolts. Okay. So the artisan table is just used like... Okay. Alright, so I need to cover this, and then the other two things I can build with it require it. Is that it? Blast furnace. Stone, certainly core, iron, fine wood, and an artisan table. So now I have a blast furnace that I have to have the artisan table for as well. So it's going to need to be built in the center of a shitload of other things. But... like the stone cutter, I only need the artisan table to build the goddamn thing. Once it's built, I don't need the artisan table to use it, right? So I can build the artisan table, build all this crap that I need, and then just delete the artisan table, because if I don't need to use the artisan table to build anything. Well, let's see. What can I even make with the goddamn thing? Let's just put it in here temporarily. Yeah. See what we can do with it. Oh, wooden missile. Sturdy wooden missiles that can provide a tough defense against foes. So these are the ballista bolts. Oh, whatever, I don't use those. Okay, so this thing is not... It is cool looking, though. With the chains and the moving parts and shit. Take a good close look at it here, yeah? It's got little bubbling thing in the center there. It's got all kinds of shit dripping and a couple of rail spikes there, some tongs, a little beaker stand or a little mini cauldron with some shit on the back. Looks like racks for tools. That's kind of cool. All right, we don't need one yet though. So go ahead and put the wood away. I will figure that out some other time. I ain't in the mood to deal with it right now. I want to go exploring, baby. It's here. Okay. Moving on. So that's a strange sort of upgrade there. Not sure what to make of that. But okay. But I'm sure I'm going to need the blast furnace for the black metal, right? Okay, so where are we going to go? We're going to go to this dot, and we need to go to 50. You know what? I'm gonna go activate Hildur's table. Let's go do that. We'll maybe go try one of the easier boss dungeons, man. Get her little bronze chest back, or silver chest back, or whatever it is. Because if you go talk to Hildur, right, she says, oh, I need help with the blah. She's up over here, right? Yeah. She's all, I got away, but my goods weren't so lucky. At least I know where it happened, whatever good that does me. Most of my stuff was stolen from me. I marked out where it was on the map in case you'd like to help me look for it. Yeah? He's like, hey girl, what up? The one thing I like about Hildur is you can rest here. Yeah? It's comfort level 1, but you can rest here and get a little bit of a recharge back. So if you use her table, right? Map location has Smoldering Tomb, Howling Something, Sealed Tower. Yeah? So now on the map, there are Howling Cavern, Sealed Tower, Howling Cavern. Looks like in the mountains. Smoldering Tomb. But yeah, they're way the hell out here. Let me take this off. Take all this off so I can see. Yeah, so the closest one we have is a Howling Cavern right here. Yeah. There's not really that many of them on here, but they're hella long ways away. But yeah, there's a inside there's a boss, and the boss has a chest that you bring back to her, and then that unlocks different things, which looks like they're mostly be like cosmetics and shit, right? I still need your help, Mark, on your map. Yeah. I do wish that developers would stop using the phrase mark it on your map. I wish they would use phrases like I'll show you where it is, or it's at the blah, or whatever. Stop telling me you'll mark it on my map. But that's Hildur. So now we got other stuff we can do. The closest one is the Howling Cavern up there in the mountains. I'm not sure if I can handle that or not. Okay, so what we're gonna do here, come back to 13. We gotta go back home here. Cause I need to get some expedition materials, yeah? We need to get our expedition materials ready to go. Because we're going to have to figure out how to build a house somewhere. But see, that's once you knock them back, when you stagger them, right? About a foot. And then when you block, they go flying. But again, they just... The block mechanics are just jacked, man. They're just really whack. And, okay, let's go back home. Okay, so we have boar meat. Let's go put the boar meat away. So I'm definitely going to have to knock out a wall of this thing and make a place to do this extended crafting, which is going to be probably this right here. I'm going to knock this wall out. So I'm going to have to redo this chest configuration here for sure. And we'll have to push this wall out a significant degree, which will be weird because then I'll have a back to this house and I'll have to fix that up somehow. But yeah, we're going to have to tackle this whole... The whole back of this thing is going to have to be reconfigured. I'm going to have to redo the storage down here. Probably to put the stone that's in there somewhere else. Yeah, the good thing is we've got a little bit of room out there. The bad thing is it's going straight towards the Black Forest. So what we may need to do instead is just punt and not use this area for the artisan table and the other stuff that I need to do. Because I'm almost positive the blast furnace is needed to smelt the black metal, right? You need to smelt black metal in the So now I'm considering, do I want to redo this or do I not? I got my little workshop set up just right. I like my little workshop right there. And I've got 16 other outposts. Well, 14. Because one's for the bees and one's for the food. Right? One's for the crops. But this is too close to the Black Forest. I don't like that. Alright, you know what? I'm going to stretch and think about this. So what we're going to do is we're going to put him in his chair here. And we're going to have him thinking. Yeah? We're going to go 3 to 5 minutes, folks. Refill your drinks and snacks. Smoke them if you got them. Stretch like I'm going to. We're going to have a moment of silence from my boy. And we'll be right back. Say hi to Mr. Beans. We are back. Yeah, Mr. Beans passed away a year today. A year today. Okay. So what are we going to do now? We are going to... Little Man's. Oh, yeah, Little Man's is fine here. Little Man's is... this guy right here. That's Little Man's. That's the current terror cat, the territorial cat. The cat who's ready to go fuck it up with some ferals. He's like, let me out, I'm gonna go kick his ass. I'm like, no, dude, your legs don't work. Go kick your ass, don't do that. Now, RIP co-pilot. So what do I want to do now? As y'all know, my first goal with every new biome is get the food. Oddly enough, neither the cloudberries nor the lox meat triggered anything new here. The cloud berries are used for some kind of... Yeah, there it is right there. Medium stamina, right? But we didn't get any new recipes. Not for the lox meat. We didn't get any new recipes for the cloud berries, which is interesting. A dragon trap. Yeah, no, I ain't doing that. So let's go ahead and get our basic tool set, and that is, we need wood, right? Let's grab the 50 here. Let's grab the 50 here. And then we're gonna grab some stone out of here. Grab some stone out of here. Gonna make our tools, right? Gonna make our basic tools. So we can make a hammer and a hoe, right? First things we do, make a hammer, make a hoe. And we upgrade those bad boys. Because we're going to need our basic tools to make a fundamental base out in the plains somewhere. Somewhere. We're going to need that. Okay, so let's put the rock back away. Right, we're prepping. We're prepping for our journey here, yes? Prepping for our journey. And I'm going to put these away so I know where they're at. And then we're going to think about what we're going to take next. Okay. So I've got that. The next thing I need to take is boat building materials, and that's, I could build a longship, but I just, a carve is fine. 30, 10, 30, 20, 10, right? Okay. 30, 20, no. 30 wood, 20 resin. We need 30 fine wood, and then we need 20 for... We need 20 resin. Let's get the resin. We need 20 resin. We need 10 deer hide. Dun, 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 dun. 10 deer hide. And then we need 80 nails. I think I've got 80 nails in here. Yeah, I do. Okay, let's get 80 nails. Dun, 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 dun. 80 nails. Then what I need on top of that is I need 10 gray dwarf eyes. Dun, 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 dun. And I need 2 certling cores. Oop, no, don't do that. Need 2 certling cores. Right, okay. So there's my ship, there's my portal. Right? Dalton, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. How's it going, sir? Can't type on space. It's hard to getting old, man. We're all getting old, man. We're all getting old. We're going to take ourselves a pickaxe. Add it to the tool set. Yeah. I can use the iron axe to chop wood if I need to, so that's fine. I need 10 wood for the workbench that I'm going to be building so I can drop the ship in the water. Yeah. I need 10 wood so I can drop the ship in the water. And there's wood on the plains, so I'm not worried about getting it out there. There's wood and stone on the plains. I can get all that shit out there to build fires and... whatever I need to do. So, okay. So there's my kit. Yeah? I got a boat, I got a portal, I got a workbench I can build here. I got a pickaxe, a hoe, and a hammer to do the basic plowing and carving and shit out there. I've got an axe so I can do that crap there. We're gonna grab... I'm gonna grab these here. And these here. And these here. How many do I have? 40? Still got 40. Okay, I got plenty of those. Teleporter things. Yeah, that's what the other stuff is. 30 of this wood is for the boat. 20 is for the portal. This is for the portal. This is for the portal. So I got the portal here. I got the boat here. I got the workbench to launch the boat. That's the basics. I can get the wooden stone and everything else I need when I get to the plains. So I've got that going. Fergie, how's it going? Welcome to the stream. So what we're going to do is we're going to sleep. Yeah, let's sleep. Let's get some daytime going. Let's get some daytime going, and let's get across the water, and let's get up to that new plains, and hopefully we don't die on the way across. But I've got a bunch of weapons, all fully repaired, doing good there. So let's eat. All right, day 260, off we go. Now we go down the shore in the meadows, and we're gonna look for a place to drop this workbench. I don't generally, some people build like a whole boat bay and shit like that. I generally don't even care. So we're gonna go this way. Right, we need to go this way. Let's get out to the shoreline and see if we can find a good place to drop this workbench, where I can put the boat in the water where it's fairly shallow. Because I want to go across to that continent over there, that island over there. So there's a little thing here. And there's that house. That house is kind of close to the plains. How does the water look here? It looks pretty good. It looks pretty good. So what we're going to do is we're going to build it on this rock. Yeah. We're going to build the workbench on this rock. I'm just going to put it right there, right? And then we're going to go to our map, and we're going to put a dot with an anchor on it, so I know that this is where I put my boat. Then we're going to drop the boat in the water. Go like this. Looks like it's pretty far out. It's going to hit the thing when I drop it, and that's fine. Perfect. Now we get our axe out. Very important. Yeah. Get your axe out, because I'm going to need to destroy this boat when I get to the other side. I want to have the axe ready to go. Alright, away we go. Paddling, because of course the wind is in our face, because why wouldn't it be? That motor power will come in handy. The mudder power will come in handy when I finally find a way to, when I finally start doing some real sailing. Yeah. Trick here is I gotta find somewhere I can run this aground. Right? I gotta find a place where I can run this aground where it's fairly shallow so I can get my nails back. Not that farming copper and tin is very, you know, challenging or exciting, but I prefer not to have to waste my time. Sea of Thieves, the beginnings. Yeah, not so much, man. I mean, the mechanics are fairly similar in terms of how you adjust the sails and shit, but it's not as involved as Sea of Thieves, yeah. This looks pretty shallow over here. This looks like my best bet here, so let's see what we got. No, it's not shallow enough. But if I can run underground at an angle, I might be able to get my ship back. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Okay, did I get my nails? Look at that knockback. You see that? Look how far he... Oh, shit. The nails are over here. God damn it. They're fucking too low and I can't swim down. God damn it. And look at that, dude. That little bug knocked me that fucking... Fuck me, dude. I lost the nails. Son of a bitch. Yeah, fuck you, dude. I lost the nails. God damn it. It's not about the nail. It is about the nails. Look how far they flew offshore, dude. That is some fucking bullshit. Can I maybe get them in this angle? Is there a way I can get them there? I saw it. I saw it. Come on, come on. Oh, it's the water going up and down, that's why. Come on, give me my fucking nails back. Oh, shit, I need these nails, dude. Come on, there we got them. Fuck yeah. Alright, we got the nails. Use the farm tool. I always forget, EB. How you doing, man? Welcome to the stream. I always forget I can do that, man. As you see here. But I got the nails. We're good. We're good. I will remember for next time, though. I don't normally have the hoe on me, right? So it doesn't occur to me that I can actually raise the ground with it. Hey, dude. Maybe I should do that next time. Beach the boat and then raise the ground around it so it stays put. That would be the smarter thing to do. If I weren't a low skills gamer, I would have done it.
Okay.
So we got our shit, we're wet, but we're on the plains. Come on, you little fuck. Come on. Round and round and round she goes. Boop. Okay. Okay. Strange new land. Here we are. Looks like there's mountains right there. So let's start cruising, babies. Let's see if I can find a place that's decent. Let's see if I can find an existing building to build off of. Because that's what I would prefer to do. Nailed it. Nailed it. Yeah, I nailed it. It's not about the nail. But it is. It's right there. You know that video is 11 years old? God, I can't even believe it's been that long. We used to vote Race the Ground on a DMC song. Maybe. Alright, let's keep going here. Oh, there's something over here. Looks like more feelings with little clubs. Ugh, something just took a shit. Come on, buddy. Come on. Nope, no, run around in circles first. Yep, look at that hit collision. Mmm, tasty. Yeah. Your enemy is not the feelings. Your enemy is not the Deskitos. Your enemy is the ground. That is your enemy in this game. And I'm wet again because who gives a fuck? Come on. Yep. Come on. I'm used to being wet. I don't care. So now we're looking for something where somewhere where I can build. Somewhere where I can build a house. That tide. Yeah, it's obnoxious, isn't it? When it storms, it can go up and down like 4 feet. Beachfront. I don't like building near the water, because the water will weather it. It won't destroy it, but it'll weather it. And I just like the silver look. I'm not gonna bother picking up cloud berries because I don't need that many of them. Although I can make a tapestry out of them once I make a white banner once I get to where I'm going. So. And I'm gonna need stone, so I might as well start picking that up too, right? So I'm gonna need to make a campfire. I got a pickaxe with me, so that's not a problem. Okay, stone, cloudberries. There's a stone down there. Let's grab that. Is that five? That's six. Okay, we got enough. Okay. We'll put the nails back down here on the bottom row. Put this here so I can see what's going on. Okay. Alright. Off we go. Looking for something that resembles a house. Because I know the fueling. I know they have villages. They're apparently. I've seen them in their plains biomes. And I see the fires at night. Yeah. So I know that they have. There are buildings I can co-opt if I find one. But I don't know what they look like. And I don't know if they can be on the coast. Good God. That's a big chunk of fucking rock right there. Damn. The good thing is I've got 9 food, which will last me 6 hours? No. Yeah. 9 times 25 is 180 and 45, 225. So about 3 hours. So I've got plenty of time before I run out of food, which is good. There's no way I can mine this, is there? Holy shit, I can cut that down. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. We're gonna have to try that sometime. Build off the rock. Yeah, you can, apparently. Build all the way up there, make a tower on the top. Uh-oh. What have we got here? We got some more fine wood I can make my tables out of. Good. Perfect. Okay, there's something up there that looks like a building, so we're good. Let's go ahead and get our loot out of this bad boy. Because there's usually... Oh, goddammit, I didn't want to do that. I wanted the other thing, this. These things have chests in them. Sometimes. I think. What they do have is a ton of fine wood. A ton of fine wood. And there's some down here. And there's some here. Yeah, fine wood for days, baby. Just because I can, yeah? Alright, cool. Okay, that definitely looks like a building of some kind, so we're gonna go over there. That's my fine wood, you got a beach there. Yeah, no kidding, right? The chest, if it has a chest, it's usually, I heard you little shit. Still, I mean, they're not a threat to me, but I still a little scarred. Because my first getting my ass handed to me moment was these little shits on my first character. Oh yeah, it's a whole village, isn't it? Okay. Well, it's time to clear you little sons of bitches out. Looks like they're fighting something. They're all cackling. Yeah, I hear you. He's come on, Mr. Fireboy. I'm immune to you, bitch. Yeah, I can't head down. Wow, there's a lot of these little fuckers in there. Oh shit, it's time to go, boys. Woohoo, time to go. No, I'm down to 40 health, dude. It's time to, oh shit. Yeah, let's go. Come on, get the stamina. There you go. Time to go. Woohoo, okay, I can take one or two, but seven's a little bit too many. Pull out the frostery? Yeah, once I get some distance, man. Okay. Alright. Here they come, yeah? Some of them are giving up, some of them aren't. But the ground's not level, yeah? The ground's not flat. Okay, two of you guys I can take. Sounds like a mountain falling on them, man. Fucking awesome. I hear you guys cackling out there. Come on. One at a time, guys. Line up and die, okay? Where you going, buddy? Ran him down and murdered him. That's what I'm talking about. Fuck you, dude. Oh, nope, that's right. Sorry, he's a foot above me. I couldn't possibly hit him. Yeah, no. Run out in the water, dude. That's fine. Fuck you. I'll leave you over there. Okay. We got our health back a little bit. Sit and duck? I think so. Eat a dick, you little shit. Alright, we're wet again. Congratulations, but we got the black metals. Okay. Get out of the fucking water, dude. Okay. Now we thin the herd a little bit. Maybe I can get the rest of them. So next time, mental note, shoot arrows. Yeah, fuck you, dude. Look at these assholes. I mean, these just run around in circles, dude. Come on, run around in circles, dude. Run around in circles. Somebody gotta play Yakety Sax. That should be the background music for the combat. It's straight up Keystone Cops bullshit, yeah? Blocked, motherfucker. How you like that? There's a lot of these guys in here, man. Blocked. Oh, and it slows them down too, doesn't it? Well, that's helpful. You got no frost resistance, boys. Why am I 446? Okay. What am I gonna drop here? I guess I really need that much fine wood, right? I got, well, 50 and 28. Now, you know what? I'm just gonna leave the black metal. I don't need it. I can't do anything with it, so whatever. And I can just get more by killing these guys, right? But hey, look at this. Julian trophy, yeah, black metal here. Okay. And skeletons? I see you, little shit. What do they have? They have pits with bones in them? Well, that's kind of cool. Come on, you little fucker. Stop running in circles, dude. Yeah, whatever. Okay. So what we're going to do here... So this is the... This is one of their villages, I guess, huh? I hear you. Oh, that's right. They can't climb down. There's another thing they need to improve, yeah? Enemies need to be able to climb down. Yeah, I see you. You can't do shit, buddy. Damn it. Can we add to the list? Can we add my arrows need to stop shooting out of my dick? They need to come out of my bow? Just saying. Okay, we're done with that bullshit. You see a chest. Yes, I saw it too. I saw it too. See what they're growing. Dandelions. There's bone fragments. Okay. Let's do this first. I'm going to claim this place right fucking now. So what we're going to do is we're going to build a fucking workbench. Yeah, I don't want them respawning. So let's go ahead and build a workbench. I don't have any wood. Because I used the wood for... This is probably core wood. Okay, first things first. Offload this crab. Oh, good. Good. Perfect. All right, let's go back and get the other black metal that we saw. Down here and here and here. And then it was over here, right? Here, here, and here. Okay, we got that going. And then they drop some back over here, I'm sure. Okay, got that. Perfect. Okay, let's put all that away. But look at this. They got tanning racks here. Is that actually a tanning rack? It sure is. I can use that. Oh, and fine. Look at all the beech trees, man. Jesus, we're going to have a problem getting fine wood. All right, so in here, let's just put the fine wood in here, and the and these, and those. Let's just go pick up all the bones, right? They'll just, yeah, we'll just pick them up. Pick them up and get them out of the way. Right, okay. Pick up all the fine wood, they got a fire, they got two fires going, pretty good, okay. Put the bones away. Okay, so I need wood now. Are these core wood or what? Let's find out. Axe. My luck, they'll be core wood. Yeah, what did I say? What did I say? My luck, they'll be core wood. Well, we'll just get these easy trees over here rather than try and chop the, like shrubs. Okay, there's some wood. All right, we got some wood. Let's build a workbench so these little shits don't respawn. Dandelions are no good. Yeah, I know. I can get dandelions in the fucking meadows, but there's nothing else here. It's just that. At least that I see so far. Come on, circle some more. Okay. Now, workbench. Stick it right under there. And it counts as cover. Score. Okay. So it's dandelions and dandelions and dandelions. What am I hearing? No, it's just the music. Okay. Okay, so, well, does it count as shelter? I can't get underneath it, so I can't tell. It definitely counts as shelter for the workbench. And I can't see. So that's a problem. So what am I going to do with this area? That's my question. What are we going to do with this area? Well, let's clear out... Actually, can I just scrap these fires and shit? Can I do this? I can just do that. Good. Okay, well, we can start tearing this shit down then. Okay. Well, shit, I could have got the stone from them. I didn't even know. What is this? Is this wood? I can't... That's wood. I should be able to... I can't do anything with these? I mean, I could axe them down, sure. I guess since I can't build them, I can't tear them down. I'll take that. I can use that for sure. Yeah, I can't tear these fences down with my build menu. I can't do anything with any of this other stuff either. And the stone lights up, but I can't do it without a stone cutter thing, so we're not gonna worry about that. Well, shit, I mean, I guess I'm gonna start hoeing stuff, right? I mean... Which way is that? Okay, so it's that way, that's straight east. It doesn't raise the ground up for shit either. Go this way. I got 2 minutes on food, so let's go ahead and eat. And then we'll go this way. I guess. And this is straight north this way. So we'll go like that. Okay, so that goes down already and I can't pull it up. Okay. Coogan, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. Yeah, a forward operating base. I'm on a new continent. Let me show you here. We're on a new continent over here. Let me get rid of this thing. Where my bases are all over here. And I'm in the plains. And this is the first little village or whatever that I've found. So, of course, I pacify it and then just repurpose it. But since I can't build any of the objects that this thing uses for buildings, I can't tear them down with my hammer. And since I can't see in the dark, I got to figure out what I'm doing here. Because I can't tell if this is level or not. It doesn't look like it. Yeah. And... If I go over this way, try and flatten this out, I put the fire out because, well, I covered it with dirt. So it's under there somewhere. Uh, And it lights itself back up. Okay, so I guess I need to get rid of this fire. So let's go ahead and take the stone for ourselves. Doesn't do any good to have it out, right? Because I need to get this ground leveled out, yeah? Around this centerpiece where my workbench is. Because until I can get my house set up, I'm going to need that workbench to fix these tools. And, okay. So now we kind of have to wait for the sun to come up because I can't see, yeah? And the ground here is not being very conducive. The good thing is I don't need to build an entire outpost. I just need to build somewhere to make a teleporter, yeah, so I can come back. Put walls around it. You know what, though? Fuck it. I can't tear it down. I can't build it, so fuck it. It's going to destroy it. God knows they're not going to need it. Deer hide? Wow. I would like to be able to build shit like this, though. It'd be kind of cool. But it doesn't appear that's going to be an option. So. This is kind of cool, though. One way to clear the area, certainly. I'd have liked to have kept it, but it's not in the cards, so whatever. I heard you. Oh, were you up in the tower and I didn't see you? Oh no, you're over there. I see the fire. Okay. Well, come on over, buddy. I hear you cackling, you little shit. Come on out. I see. There you are. Come on. Thanks for ringing the fire so I can see you, you little motherfucker. Okay. That's most of it, so I guess this support's the only ones left, huh? Alright. Now that whole thing's gonna come down, so good. Isn't it? There we go. That was the last one. Okay. Still fun to watch this. Dun-dun-dun. It'll figure it out. Doo-doo-doo. We gotta wait for the sun to come up anyway, so what the fuck? We might as well watch this thing come down, yeah? Come on. You can do it. Kind of a shame that I couldn't use this, though. Nathan, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. They must use Bethesda logic. Well, the thing is, we watched it happen 1 week. On a Draugr village. And what it does, seemingly, right, is every time a piece disappears, it starts recalculating support on everything that's left. Yeah? It doesn't cascade from bottom to top, right? Like this one piece we had, it was a roof piece that was floating, and every time it would destroy one piece attached to the roof, Then the room would turn green. Then it'd go yellowish green, yellow, orangeish, yellow, orange, yep, then red. And then another piece would drop, and it would reset to green again as it cycled through the calculations. So it's constantly circulating through the calculation. It will all eventually come down. It just takes it longer than you think it should because it doesn't retain the structural test of the thing it's using as an anchor piece when it takes the next piece down. Yeah? So it can get, oh, this is not helpful. Oh, God. Okay, well, I guess we'll do what we can in the mist. Fuck it. We're done. I'm just done. I'm just tired of this. When you gotta do this every half hour or so, you know there's a problem. Oh, it's realistic. Oh, it's realistic. Really, realistic. Spend a lot of time in the Norse afterlife? Just asking. Overcomplicate. Oh, I see what you're saying. Okay, well, yeah, definitely there. Why use 3 steps when you can use 40? Okay, let's put some shit away. Let's put the black metal in there. Yeah? Okay. Okay. Oh, I turned them off. So the thing is, it clears... Okay, so it doesn't clear the dev commands toggle until you exit the game completely. Right, okay. But it clears the environment. It clears all the stuff that you... Oh, I see. Okay. Okay. Give me some clear. Use 40 kick. Games crash at step 26. Exactly. Exactly. All right, here we go. Okay, here we go. Now I can friggin' see, yeah? So I take it, Aviator Raider, that those little pits that we see here are gonna have something I'm gonna need in one of the fueling camps if I find one. Does that sound about right? Because you all see what they're growing. I'm like, okay, so that's where you get whatever it is that you're after. Okay, so here. Right, okay. So it's even this way, and it goes this way. Right, and this is north. I always like to line my buildings up north, south, east, west, cardinal directions, because it makes the ground easier to manipulate. It behaves better when you hit it with a pickaxe. What we're going to do right here. If I can get that down there, go across here. Okay, we need a pickaxe. We need a pickaxe right there. Right here. Okay, right there. Do some sculpting here, yeah? So we've got this. Okay. You know, I wonder what happens if I get rid of these. Will that thing fall down? It probably will. Seven days to die. I tried one of those games, and it was... The intro, the tutorial, let's say. If I'm thinking of the right game, the tutorial was too difficult for me to figure out. I couldn't figure out what I was supposed to be doing, or what was valuable, or what, you know, whatever. But I vaguely remember playing it, or trying it, because it was on Game Pass. Okay, this is going to take fucking forever. Jesus Christ, dude. On Xbox, yeah, I'm almost positive that I tried it out in here. some game like that. Maybe it was something else. Because there's a bunch of those zombie survival games like that, right? Okay, good. Seven days to die. But it was like you had to go through houses and gather shit, and there were zombies running around the street, and you didn't have. I remember ammo being hard to find, and guns being hard to find, and the physics being a little bit janky. Like combat movement wasn't smooth. An old alpha build. Okay, so that's what it was then. That makes sense. But it wasn't, I couldn't figure out, it was telling me to, I couldn't, what was it? I was just confused by the whole thing. Go down zombies. Well, okay, so it does take the whole thing down. All right, that's fine. It's funny you say that because I've been playing, thanks to Draco, at Pimp His Channel right now. He's been doing State of Decay 2, so I fired it back up. And I've been playing it a little bit over the last week, because there's this new mechanic they have where there'll be a Red Talon guy telling you go to a cell tower. You go to the cell tower, and the cell tower tells you, oh, it's not here. There's a supply drop somewhere nearby. So you go to it, and it gives you a weapon. It gives you a gun and a melee weapon and a advanced break and a note. And a cosmetic. Well, the cosmetic is random. And I've gotten all the cosmetics except one. So I'm basically playing this community until I get that last cosmetic. So I log in, play for 15 minutes, wait for that mission to come up. If it doesn't, I just log out. Right? And of course, my luck is legendarily shitty. Starkiller, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. My luck is legendary in its shittiness, so I have not gotten it yet. And I've gotten, like, I don't know, maybe 25 of those drops so far. But I'm of the mind that there's something janky under the hood of State of Decay's RNG. It doesn't act right. It doesn't, its distribution is all fucked up. So it might be bugged. PC version of 7 Days does, but actually gets updated. They make promises. But okay, that's why. So I was playing an older janky. Did you kill Modder? Oh, yeah. We cheesed the shit out of her, dude. She got stuck between rocks. She would land and not get back up. It was really kind of sad, Starkiller. It was really kind of sad. I mean, I'm on very easy, but I could have set the difficulty to very cheesy on that one because it was just her hitbox, her flight mechanics, everything's just janky. Yeah. And I felt bad killing her, dude. I'm not going to lie. I felt bad killing her. Because it was just so fucked up. Like the first time, right, I summoned her, right? Finally figured out how to summon her. Summoned her. She flew around a little bit, threw some ice crystal spikes at me, landed between two rocks, and got stuck for about a minute and a half. She would attack me, yeah. But she wouldn't fly, land, move, or nothing. So if I got low on health or stamina, I just walked back 4 steps. She couldn't hit me. And I'm like, this is kind of sad, man. This is kind of sad. I'm gonna go kill her again, I'm sure, because I want the trophy to mount on my wall. But it was just, I felt bad for her, man. It's just, you know. And then to top it off, she drops tears, and I'm like, oh, isn't that a kick in the nuts? So yeah, it was just bad. I mean, we killed her. We got the tears. We got that, you know, the thing. Her power is the wind is always at your back, which is holy shit. And when you're in the boat. I'm like, that's a good power. I will use that. I will definitely be using that. But in the main, she clearly needs a lot of work, man. I mean, it was just bad. Do the egg summon? Yeah, you need 3 of them. When you go to her little altar, there's 3 divots, so you need 3 eggs. Yeah. You put the eggs in the divots, and then once you've done that, you click the sigil or whatever that is right in front of him, and it summons her and starts the fight. But I didn't know you needed three eggs, so we spent a little time. We spent a little time running back and forth to the eggs I'd marked, grabbing them, and just running back. It was like whatever. But it was not terrible. I mean, it was terrible because it was sad. It wasn't terrible because it was terrible. It would have been a really epic fight if she'd have worked right. Yeah, let's put it that way. It would have been really fucking cool if she'd have worked right. If she'd have landed normally, you know, if her landing animation had been more like a flop, you know, like she would just plummet to the ground and just kind of go thud. If she had a smoother landing animation and she wasn't so broken, it would have been a lot more epic. I mean, as someone who doesn't really care about the boss battles, I'm just glad we got it done and it was easy. They didn't die. Pretty happy. But for someone who was like gearing up for this and that was the reason they like to play this game, there would have been significant disappointment. Yeah. I mean, we did it pretty quick. We did it pretty early on. So if you rewind the stream later on, it'll be in the first 20 minutes. It didn't take long at all. But it was just, I felt bad for her, dude. It was just sad. I'm like, she can't fight back, dude. She's helpless. You know? She's helpless, her mechanics are broken, and she's just like, okay, well, whatever. Okay, so we got all that going. And if I face inland, that's probably my best. That's a big fucking rock, man. Uh-oh, what have we got over there? What's that over there? That looks like a stone building over there. Okay, this looks like it's gonna be about right. We need to drag this area out straight. So let's go ahead and get this out here. Let's do a little more terrain manipulation here. Is that going to be good enough? Oh yeah, it's going to be plenty of room. Okay. So I am going to build my my normal little hut here because I can. I've got the room for it. Yeah. And if we're going to put the thing on the right, then it's going to go here, right? If we do it here, go back to about there. Yeah, we'll try that. Try that here. And we go here, and there, here, here, here. How does that look? Let's see what we get. Let's see what the form factor looks like when I get it all set up. Yeah. And there. Okay, how does that look? Yeah, that's not terrible. It's pretty well done. Let's go ahead and do some more hoeing out here, though, because we're going to need more room out in front of this thing to build the wall. Let's give ourselves a little more room out in front. Yeah. And on the side there. Yeah, that looks pretty good. That looks pretty good. Yeah, that'll work. How much wood do I have on me? 50, 13, 17? Yeah, I could probably do this. All right. Let's get this shit started. I do enjoy doing this, by the way. I mean, it's the same thing over and over, right? But it's like, it's something I can do, and it's something that I know works, so I'm really happy about it. It's like, okay, I know I can do this. As a low-skills gamer, having tasks that you're able to do, hugely, hugely satisfying. We've seen this a dozen times, I know. It won't take long, though. Gotten pretty good at it. And then bottom three. Bottom one, bottom two, bottom three. Right. And then we go miscellaneous, do the fire, la-da-da-da. Right, and then we do building. We do this one. Do that there, right? And then we do the backwards one. We turn it all the way around, snap it there. But when we switch back to the other one, it'll be facing the right way. Yeah, baby. And then we put the roof. Where's my roof? Here's my roof here. La-di-da-di. One, two, three, four. And then, oh shit, I gotta put up the chimney. God damn it, I don't want fire to go out. Forgot to finish the chimney. Getting so excited about the roof, forgot about the chimney. 3 and 4. And then we switch to the other one. We go 1 and 2 and 3. And we do the X right there. Yeah. No, come on, right there. And then we do the low roof, not the high roof. We used to do the high roof, but I like the way the low roof looks. It makes it look a little bit round, which is kind of cool. No, not like that. Dumb fuck. Like that. And then we'll go ahead and put the other roof up here. And we're going to put some floors in here. No, we have to put the other wall up first. Because otherwise, for whatever reason, until I put this outside wall up, it will not count as covered for the workbench. Probably gonna need to chop some wood, but it's daytime, so we should have some time left to do this. Come on, go in there. Right there. Oh, we need more wood. Okay. Let's go get some more wood. God damn, it's all birch trees out here, dude. Holy shit. I was sweating getting fine wood. I'm like, we're drowning in this shit. You've been stealing my house layout? Dude, everything on the channel is free to use. Steal away. Knock yourself out, man. I'm flattered that you think it's worth stealing. Okay. I hear you, you little fucker. Come on out, man. No, 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 no! Do not go in the water. Death by log, you little shit. I'll get that thing later. Come on. Yeah, over his head, dude. He's 6 inches below me, and he might as well be fucking invincible, yeah? It's so stupid, man. The hit collision is so fucking stupid. Don't buy this game until they fix that. It's so dumb, dude. It's so dumb. I mean, look at this spear, dude. It's 6 feet long. Okay? I can stab things on the ground 4 feet in front of me, dude, and still have plenty of room left over. But not here. Nope. Nope. That back brace he's got, it just prevents that kind of thing from happening. Pretty location. Yeah, I've been looking forward to the plains my entire... The whole time, dude, I've been wanting to go to the plains, man. Because I would see it in screenshots. Dude, it looks really nice, man. It looks really... Enemies are beneath me. Oh, channeling Groucho there. I see. Yeah, they're all beneath me. And 6 inches beneath me, and that means there might as well be a... Spear's considered a ranged weapon. Yaha! I heard you, little fucker. Well, it's a melee weapon, dude, but the thing is, let me show you what the problem is here, Freedom Man, and why it's so fucking, why it's so cheese, okay? The ancients used to use spears to fish, okay? Because you can see the spear, the shaft, is about 6 feet long, okay? But when I swing with it, well, let me see, let me get on a place where you can see his feet. Yeah, we'll go up here. That's a good spot right here. But if I swing with it, he only hits to like his knee. So literally everything below his knees is completely invulnerable. He cannot hit it. If I use the alternate attack, it throws the spear. So it's a ranged and melee weapon. But the fact that a 6 foot spear of ash can't hit below, like he can't adjust his grip. He won't, his back is stiff. Look at his back, dude. Look at the animation. His back is straight. He's wearing a back brace, dude. That's the problem. Yeah. It's a good looking game. I know it is, right? And yet people bitch because the graphics are chunky, right? Like this, you know, you see the Doom and Quake era graphics. Well, I love it, dude. Of course, I grew up in that era, so, you know, of course I'm going to like them, right? Come on, you little fucker. Circle around a bunch, too. It's So yeah, that's where we're at. That is just the most obvious demonstration of the problem. Yeah, the fact that with the six foot thing that I can use for range and reach, I can't hit anything below my knees. It's like, what? Maybe he has scoliosis. I don't know. I just know he can't bend at the waist. So, yeah. It's aggravating, you know? Because it doesn't make sense. Because the entire reason to make the spear was to hit things at any elevation. So you could get fish out of the water without having to have a rod and reel. You just spear the fuckers, yeah? Not this guy. I can't even spear him when I'm in the water because I put my weapon away when I'm swimming. It's like, okay, well. So that's one thing that's a real problem. That's one of the real problems here. Is that Rockefeller jank. Let's see. Let's go ahead and build ourselves. We're not gonna need to cook here, so I'm not gonna worry about that. We're gonna put some wall, get some floors in here. Yeah. What I wanna do is get that workbench in here. I can just fill this floor in, which I can't because I'm out of wood. But okay, that's fine. But we've got enough to do the rest of it. So let's go ahead and take these walls down. This will be a lot of wood. Yeah, good. I'll be able to finish the rest of it now. Okay. And here? Oh, I need a workbench first. Haha, forgot. Let's put it in here. Right. Now we put the floor back in, yeah? Cool. Here and there. Okay, I gotta bio really quick, guys. So give me about 90 seconds, guys. I'll be right back. All right. Let me see. Spear range weapon. Good looking game. Rockefeller. Jesus Christ. Sorry. Did I get you, day? Right about now. The back brace Viking. Check it out now. The back brace Viking. Okay. Thank you very much, Noel. Good to be back. Feeling a little refreshed there. Okay. Where are we at? We got 16 wood, huh? Well, let's go ahead and build a bed. Let's do that first. Let's build a bed. Yeah. And let's build ourselves. Da 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 da. Build ourselves. Build ourselves a deer rug. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Wait a minute. I saw. Didn't I see? I got 10 flint. Where the hell did I get flint from? Probably from taking down these fueling things, huh? Shit, I'm gonna need more wood, man. Well, we ain't resting yet. We ain't resting yet. Crypto Shablar. I wish I could. I wish I could, dude. I don't have the option. He doesn't have a grip shift. The combat physics aren't that complicated. Yeah. Which is good. Easier to balance. Easier to fix, you know, because of the simplicity. But when they don't work, well, you gotta wonder why it hasn't been addressed. But I don't care. I mean, this is on Game Pass, dude. I ain't paying for it, so whatever. I'd be happy to buy it, but not until it works right. Yeah. Get some more wood here. Wait a minute. But yeah, the music's perfect. Yeah, violins and strings, really good. First for $20, I think they'll change more in full release. As far as I know, right, I don't really pay attention look at the subreddit to get information on, you know, tactics and shit that I don't know. But in general, I don't follow this game very closely. Yeah. I just look at the change notes and shit. Yeah. And I noted that the change notes, the last ones for the Xbox were in December. Well, we're almost in April, dude. And apparently they are working on the last biome, Ashlands. And they're targeting a June 30th. Well, they're saying a first half 2024, right? So he's like, oh, yeah, it'll be June 30th, June 29th, and whatever the fuck. Like I said, I don't have that much investment, so I don't care. But, for $20, it ain't bad. I just don't have that kind of. I just don't. Okay. Let's go ahead and just go slow and say, look. Over the last couple of years, between the declining quality standards in gaming in general, between the push for MTX, between the complete gutting of the industry because of poor management, okay? Poor management, poor staffing, poor financial decisions, along with the typical profit, 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 right? And the fact that studios are growing, but they're not getting any better because they're gutting all their fucking intellectual expertise by laying off people all the fucking time, closing studios and shit, yeah? So what you're going to see, I think, in the next couple of years is a renaissance. You're going to see a lot more indies coming out, a lot fewer AAAs, a lot more indies, because they're lower risk, lower budget, and technically higher return. Plus, there'll be better games. So pure vision, less dilution from management and finance, less bullshit from the top. You know, there'll be fewer cooks in the kitchen, so to speak, right? So you get better games like this one, okay? From a design standpoint, this game is fucking amazing, okay? I wish every game were designed this well. It has faults, certainly. It's not perfect. But in terms of its systems, its mechanics, its goal, its drive, and literally everything that makes it a game is done perfectly. It literally works exactly like you expect it to, except for the spear. But that's a coding issue, a design issue, right? That's something you can fiddle with later. But the gestalt of the game, it holds together perfectly, right? It's not this half-assed feature buffet that doesn't have any relation to anything else, right? Like in this game, your weapons, your food, your armor, your buildings, literally everything serves the goal of getting you through the game to the next boss. You can't neglect anything, yeah? In other games, you could just completely not even do a complete subsystem and it doesn't even matter. So it's like, okay, so what's going to happen, where we're going to go, is I'm not going to pay for non-finished products anymore by a developer team. Right now, there's like 13 people, Nathan. Right now, there's like, it's like a 13 people crew, plus they have like 16 more people doing the Xbox port, right? So there's like a dozen people working on this game. But yeah, it started with two, dude. Started with two, yeah? And it was five for a long time. But as it grows, as it gets better and closer to release, they need, you know, more eyes on it, more hands on deck, whatever. That's normal. Okay, I get it. But the original vision hasn't been diluted, yeah? What that means for me as a consumer, as a gamer, okay, is I no longer buy promises. I don't buy unfinished fucking products. I don't buy broken shit. I don't buy things that need more work. And not stuff that's like, oh, I wish it had this feature, it should have this feature. I'm talking about my spear doesn't hit below my fucking knees. That's a major glaring flaw, okay? So for myself personally, as I get on my fucking soapbox again, I'm no longer going to reward suboptimal performance with money. I will buy the Xbox Game Pass, and I will play games on the Game Pass. And they can derive whatever revenue they get from my concurrent login, from my daily whatever the fuck, AUS, whatever statistics they use to get revenue from their Xbox contract. I am more than willing to let them have that. Yeah. Okay. But I'm not going to pay for it until it's done. And until it fucking works. And is it sad that those conditions leave about 85% of the current games on the shelf? Is that my problem? No. So if you want more than the bare minimum than your Xbox contract from me, I would suggest fixing your broken shit. Maybe play testing it. Maybe listening to the people who are criticizing your game rather than your fucking cheerleaders. Okay? Because nothing will kill a gamer nothing will kill a game faster than developers who listen to their cheerleaders and not their critics. Okay? You can take that shit to the bank. So, thanks for coming to my fucking TED Talk, I guess. But I looked at the current state of games, right? I was like, what do I want to play? I don't know. And my first question is, what works? You know? Which of these games actually works? I don't fucking know. Which of them won't corrupt my saves? Which one of them won't wipe out my progress? Which one of them won't fuck me over every time I turn my back? I don't know. The odds are most of them will. And it's like, well, why am I paying for this again? I'd be happy to give you my money, dude. I am all about rewarding good performance. But until I get good performance, you're not getting rewards. Show me the money. And it's sad that it has come to this. It is sad that there are like three developers I can think of that I would trust enough to probably make a day one purchase. Yeah. The rest of them, fuck them. I mean, they literally die. It's like, well, seeing how the industry has changed over the decades. It just grew, dude. That's all. It just grew. It happens to every industry. They grow. People see money in it. And then they go, and then they start focusing on the money instead of the reason they started to make money in the first place. Yeah. It's just the nature of the beast. That's something that you can just not have to worry about. That's something that's never going to change. But. Let me go read back here. Game Pass is great for trying new games. Game Pass is great for playing games. Because here's the thing, okay? Games that are available on Game Pass have a very... I'm trying to catch up with chat. I'm going to go ahead and just keep on editorializing while I'm hacking down fucking trees. Game Pass is great for the consumer, but it is really bad for the developer. Okay. Oh, because the developer's getting ripped off. No. What it's doing is it's detaching the developer from their consumer. Okay. Case in point. When you go to the movies and you pay your $7 for a movie ticket, do you give a shit what studio it was? Do you even care? If you're not a movie nerd, do you even know? Well, yeah, you'll see it you'll see it after the previews are over and you know the movie starts. They show you all the production studios and shit like that. But the question I have for you is this: Is the studio a deciding factor in which movie you see? No, it's not. You don't even fucking care who it is. Because you're not paying them. You're paying the goddamn movie theater, right? Same thing with Game Pass. Okay? I am paying Microsoft to play games. I'm not paying Iron Gate. Microsoft is paying Iron Gate. Okay? So the game is a service now. It's not a product, right? I don't have any incentive to purchase this game unless I want to play it offline, or I'm afraid it will go off of Game Pass someday. Okay. Fair. Right? Cool. So why do I give a shit what happens to Iron Gate? Why am I invested in them as a studio? I'm not. I'm invested in Game Pass, dude. I want to make sure I can still play games. And if something happens, this game goes off of there, I have a choice. Do I, A, try and fucking, you know, buy the game, go through Microsoft's store and buy the game, or do I just say fuck it and play another game? I don't know. Maybe play another game, dude. What are you doing, dude? No, you don't get to run off. You don't get to attack me and then run off, homie. So, what can we do for more profit? Okay. That's a different discussion that I'm not going to get into right now, Freedom Man. Because I don't have enough knowledge or expertise, quote unquote expertise, on that particular subject. But the thing is, right, it detaches the developer from the consumer, from the gamer. The gamer no longer gives a shit about the developer because they're not buying from the developer. They're not dealing with the developer. They're dealing with the service provider. Yeah. So am I hearing something? So that's bad. Because then gamers won't be invested and they won't be incentivized to send in bug reports or to send in comments or whatever, because in most cases they won't even know who the developer is anymore, because they don't matter. They're interested in the service, yeah? And while that's good, it keeps, you know, the rabid fans from, you know, sending you death threats and shit, right? It's bad overall because you have gamers who are more and more detached from your game. They're less and less invested. They don't have a reason to care. Yeah? And that's, in my opinion, fairly bad. Yeah? That's a bad thing. But it is what it is, because that's the thing. Right? Not our gamers monkey, so just go fund me to game rant to the developer. Shit. Nobody's gonna fucking listen to me, dude. I'm just one goddamn consumer. And see, that's the thing too. People go, how do you affect change? Oh my god, we need Bethesda to do something about 76. Oh my god, blah 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 blah. Okay, you wanna get their attention? Have you and 10,000 of your friends on the same platform not log in for a month. Do that. Well, I'm not gonna do that. Well, then you're not gonna see any change, homie. Okay, they pay attention to the numbers, the demographics, the statistics. They don't give a shit about you, dude. Nor should they. You're just one. You're just one wallet, dude. Who fucking cares what you think? But if you want to get their attention, you have to do it in a massive way, right? Because that'll get the attention of the people who give them their money, and that will wake them up. Yeah. They say, oh well, you know, but Bethesda needs to fix all these bugs. They don't get their shit together. Blah 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 blah. Take your fall first, cancel it, dude. You and 10,000 of your friends, cancel it. Make that revenue stream dry up. I guarantee you that will get their fucking attention, okay? What you do with it, well, that's entirely up to you. But that's what it's gonna take to affect change, and no one's gonna do that, because it's an entertainment product. They wanna keep playing. I know what that's like. Sometimes I can't play a game, I'm like, I'm fucking pissed, I wanna play. But, you know, that's just how it goes. And, miss having physical copies of games. Yeah, I mean, well, you can't play them offline anymore anyway, so the biggest problem starts with developers are profit-driven versus quality-driven consumer. I'm going to disagree with you, Freedom Man. The developers are not profit-driven. Their management is profit-driven. The money people, right? The developers, I'm going to go out on a limb here based on my knowledge of having interviewed many, many, many developers back in the day, I would wager there are almost no developers, or very, very few, who give a shit about money past the fact that, can this pay for what I want to do? Yeah? Developers just want to make good games, dude. That's all they want to do. And I swear to God, I have yet to meet a developer who is not totally fucking excited about what they're working on, because they're living the dream, right? They're making the game they want to play. Yeah. But they need money to do that. Yeah. They need money. And semantics, head on. There you go. Okay. I agree with that. My problems with Bethesda, haven't dropped a bug-free game ever, which is, again, it's impossible to drop a bug-free game. I can deal with bugs if the game is good, Nathan. I can't deal with bugs when the game is bad. I'm willing to tolerate a certain level of jank, understanding very well that no game is perfect. Yeah. I mean, Minesweeper, okay, but I mean, games are complicated, right? And since there's no real standards for anything, they have to reinvent the wheel every time they make a game. That's why they're fucking weird. I get that. I don't have any problem with that. What I have a problem with is when the bugs aren't being used in service of a game that's good, yeah, or that's entertaining, or oh, I need coal for this. Ain't that a bitch? I need coal for a white banner. Okay, sure, Jan. Yeah, I'm not going to point fingers at any given particular studios here. That's not the intent. It's just an overall trend of consumers are putting up with more and more jank and getting less and less value for their dollar over time. And need the X over the door first. Yeah, it's true. I got to finish this thing, huh? It's only got 25 wood left, but maybe we can do it. Maybe we got enough to do it. Need to build a wall, but I can't believe it's all birch out here, man. That's just weird to me. So that's where I'm at in terms of games. And an additional fun part of this dynamic is, as a skills limited gamer, my options are already limited what I get to play. Yeah. So I'm kind of stuck, right? It's going to be harder and harder and harder for me to find a game that's even I want to play, much less want to pay for. Not then that's to be fair, I'm not a pirate. Oh, everything should be free. No, everything's not free. I should absolutely have to pay for. I am absolutely willing to pay for a quality working product. When you start selling those, you will get my money. But I'm no longer going to pay for promises, and I'm not going to be patient. I'm not going to wait for you to finish the job. Yeah, finish the fucking job before you ship the thing, dude. Okay. Oh, well, game development is hard. Yeah, I know. That's why you're making millions of dollars doing it. Okay. Don't cry to me how hard it is, dude. Don't tell me how hard you worked, homie. Show me how much you got done. That's what I want to see. Okay. Because that's what I'm paying for. I'm not paying for A for effort. I'm not paying for your fucking promises. Okay. Show me what you did. Show me what you got done. And what you got done, if it's not acceptable, well, I'm not going to buy it. Sorry. But you'll still play it. Well, yeah, because it's concluded in the service. So why wouldn't I? It'd be foolish to not play something that's entertaining, that's worth exactly what I'm paying for it. The 6 cents a month that you're getting from Microsoft for putting it on Game Pass. And the promotional opportunity, because I saw it. Okay, what is this? What have we got over here? This is a stone structure, but it's got the fueling awnings on it. Uh-oh. We got bones. Is that a tar pit? Oh, tar babies. No, 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 no. I don't like you. Get away from me. Oh, no, 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 no. Oh, my God. What the fuck, dude? Yeah, what the fuck is this? God damn, dude. Tarred and poisoned? No, stop hitting me, dude. Get out of here. What the fuck, dude? Okay, this is some bullshit. Okay. I guess I gotta count on the knock. Dude, how the fuck? I'm gonna die here, dude. Shit, get out of here. Go, 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 go. Stop hitting me, motherfucker, dude. How the fuck? Go, 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 go. Go, go, run, dude, run. What in the actual fuck is that bullshit? Okay. So, fuck you. That's some bullshit. Okay? No, fam. What the fuck is that? Dude, that's... Nah. New enemies, yeah. No, that's bullshit. They need to go away. Because I haven't used the teleporter yet, and I haven't used the bed yet. Okay, so it slows and it poisons and it jumps around and it's almost immune to blunt. Look at the knockback on this shit! Okay, there you go. There's my problem, right? Massive amounts of knockback. Massive amounts of knockback, and it slows me at the same time. Okay? Miss me with that bullshit. That's weak and that's lazy. I got a trophy out of it, though. Weak and lazy. That's what that is. Weak and lazy. Okay, so we're not going up there. We got to finish this first. Shadowzar, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. Welcome to Low Skills Gaming Theater. Those things are bullshit. So do I get any ability to not get slowed? Is there anything I can make out of this that I can use to not get crippled when I get knocked back 96 feet? Okay, there we go. New build pieces. Shingle roof ridge, single roof corner. Oh, so this is where those roofs come from. Dark wood beam. Yeah, fuck those guys. Hot tub? Really? A hot tub? Seriously, a hot tub? Oops, didn't mean to drop the hammer. Put it in there. Okay, those things are bullshit, dude. Sorry, that's bullshit. Now, like I said, if the combat and movement mechanics weren't so jank, they wouldn't be so bad, but... Okay, so what we need to do now is we need to set our bed here, right, clean the bed. Then we need to zoom in here. We need to go here and go 18. Right. Okay. So why we go back home. Okay, so we're staying away from the tar pits because those things are bullshit. They wouldn't be so bad as they wouldn't be so bad if the Street Fighter ludicrous level of knockback combined with the slow made them literally unkillable. Yeah? Have a problem with that part of it. And this is 18, right? And boom. Okay, so now we can get back home. Okay. Sardelia have Minecraft stream. I don't play Minecraft. I tried it once. I don't get it. It's not my cuppa. It's not my cup of tea. Let's see what we got going here. I'm assuming. I'm hoping that they don't spawn infinitely. That's not a spawner, but that's something that they'll... Yeah? You wanna cackle, you little son of a bitch? Come on. Stop running around in fucking circles. Yeah. Fuck you, dude. Like that? Okay, that guy's got a club. Come on, big boy. Guy's got fire. God damn it. Okay. Let's keep an eye out for those little sons of bitches. How many are in there? At least three. There's a bunch of it's just bubbles coming up from the tar pit. Okay. Yeah, you assholes stay out there. Let's see what we got in here. Well, if you're gonna stand there and look at me, I'm gonna stab you, dude. Okay, so here we are. And there's the tar pit. I missed. Can tar pits be lit on fire? I don't know. Logically, they can, but logically, a 6-foot shaft should hit below my knees. Did I get his attention? Looks like there's three of them in there. Yeah, I got his attention. I'll see what he does. I'm gonna stay here in case he knocks me off. I'll fall into the pit. But yeah, you can't get up here, you son of a bitch. You can't climb. Okay, so now what happens is if I go down here, right? If I get him to come in the doorway, which he did, right? I can corner his dumb fucking ass and murder him. But I lost my access at the top because he killed it. So, or I did. So what we do, get their fucking attention, bring them over in here, and that way if they knock me back, I literally can't go back more than a couple of feet. And, what? Okay, there we go. Not gonna work. Okay. So now what we do, use the arrow, bring him out. Come on, buddy. There he is. Come on, big fella. Get your ass in here. Let me show you what it looks like when tactics are used against you, you fuck. Come on in here. I know you can come in here, you bitch. But you can't knock me back in here, you fuck. Come on. I'm right here, dude. That's right. Here I am. Yeah, whatever. You do that, dude. Come on in, motherfucker. There you go. Are you serious? Yeah, eat a dick, you piece of shit. All right, where's your buddy? Anybody left? There's one more, two more. You know what? I'm getting this out of the way. Okay. All right. 9 minutes? Okay. Let's do this shit. Do you have fire arrows? Not on me. I got them back at my camp, at my base. They do pretty good against, I mean, I do pretty good with this thing here. If I can just get them to follow me in here, they can't knock me back. Look at that shit, dude. A slime thing. A slime thing's getting damaged to stone, dude. Are you serious with this shit? Fine. Where's the last one? Is there any of them left? No. Okay, good. They're all gone. Oh, no. There's one way over there. Can I kill this? Bone fragments? I don't need those. I'm guessing I will die if I go in there, so we're not going to go in there. Yeah, I see you, fucker. Come on. Follow me in here, buddy. Come on. I'm jumping. I know you hear me. There he comes. Come on, asshole. Where is he? There he is. Yeah, you son of a bitch. Oh, are you kidding me with this? Are you fucking kidding me with this? Jesus fucking Christ, the knockback is so stupid. These things stay dead. Well, they have so far. So, okay, bring fire arrows for these assholes. That's fine, we'll do that. Yeah, this is the La Brea Sar Pit right here. You can't really harvest anything from it, I guess. And these are just bones, so whatever. I'll throw the bones in the pit for future archaeologists. Okay, so there's that. That was not cool. But, okay. So there we are. Oh, there's a fueling. Let's go kill this ant. Let me go kill something that I know how to kill. Come on, boys. Two of you? Three of you? Oh, you're below me. I can't hit you. Shit. Come on. Come on. Get me to a point where I can actually hit you. See, I'm trapped, right? I have to stay where I can hit them. Lights out. Okay. All right. Oh, wait. Runestone. Gotta check out the new, The Locks are mighty creatures, great Earthshakers who roam the plains of Valheim long before the Forsaken vanish this realm. They are quick to anger and will crush any who are foolish enough to approach them unguarded. But they have known the hand of man and can be taught to love it again. That sounds a real slash Vicky, guys. Gotta tell you, that's yeah. That's real slash Vicky, folks. I swear. Okay. Yeah. I do like the plains that you can see a long way, man. I can hear a long way, too. I see you. You guys patrol in groups, don't you? Yeah, you do, you fuck. Which is kind of good, though, because I'm going to need to kill a lot of you if you're black metal. Come on, homie. Stop dancing around. There you go. Paste his ass hard with that spear. Okay, so far, I can make nothing new. Yeah? Well, that's not true. I can make a windmill. I can make a forge, blast furnace or whatever, which I'm pretty sure. Skeleton? Dude, what the hell are you doing out here? And more importantly, where did you come from? Oh, over here. See, that's the thing. Skeletons are always guarding something. I just need to figure out what and where. Give me your shit, you little punk. Yeah, bone fragments. Where were the skeletons coming from? Well, we're definitely going to be exploring this goddamn thing next week, because now I know to stay away from tar pits. I know how to handle locks. I can handle feelings. And I can handle mosquitoes. So, we're going to call this a marginal win. I heard you. Come on. Where are you at, you little fucker? There's a mosquito. Thankfully, they glow at night, so I can see their little tails. Hey, buddy. How's it going, guys? Oh, that's right. He's below me. Sorry. He's 2 inches below me, so I'll never be able to hit him. Yeah, they need to fix that jank, dude. And now. Okay, y'all done? Cool. Okay, let's get back to my little, well, the music started. I thought it was something else coming after me. All right. Okay, we're going to put that glop away in here. And we're going to put this shit in here. And the leather goes there. The black metal goes here. Let's put it in a separate chest. Yeah, let's do that. Okay. And then was over here? They were over here? So she's scared of dead mosquitoes. I have PTSD on them. Yeah, because my first character went up into the plains. Was going around the coast of a... Was doing exploring in a boat. Going around the coastline. And two of them came out and just bodied her right there in the water. Ever since then, I've been like, okay, we're done with mosquitoes. So I'm about to get my shit, right? And they just annihilated me again. I was like, nope. We're not doing that. Okay, so we're done with this shit. Oh, save. Okay. So we're going to put that in here. And let's see. We're going to take back this. How much does that shit weigh? 2 pounds apiece. Okay. We're going to take all of this. I know I'm overburdened. I don't care. We're going to leave that there for now. Let's just go back home. They hit a lot harder than cave crickets, dude. Deskitos on normal difficulties and higher difficulties, dude. Oh, sushi hated blood bugs. Oh, okay. I see. I'm like, I don't understand the reference. Of course, that's because I'm a, not the sharpest knife in the drawer, as they say. So we're going to waddle over here, and we're going to stick this in the box if we can. We're going to make it? Yeah, we're going to make it. Okay. Okay, so I've got 56 of that shit. A tar? That's building stuff, isn't it? What am I going to do with that crap? Well, let's put the nails away. It's not about the nail. And the Deskito shit goes in here? No. Here. There. You know what? Let's put the tar in there, and we'll take the trophy. We'll leave it in there for now. I'm not dealing with it right now. And then we'll put the money in the box here. Fix all of our shit. All right, so next week is going to be fairly different. An eagle-sized mosquito. Yeah, I would not be. I'm not a big fan of bugs that are as big as my head. Not really something I would be interested in cavorting with, shall we say. But anyway, sorry, I didn't mean to go on a complete fucking tangent today. But it's been something that's been on my mind lately, because it's like I can't think of a game in the past 3, 4, 5 years that didn't release with significant issues right out of the box. Yeah? And people still pre-ordered the shit. It's like, well, you want to pre-order, dude, you pre-order. You want to pay for a promise? You better hope they ain't lying, homie. Or that they're giving you bad information. Or they're giving you hopeful information. Yeah? Instead of realistic information. Because that's the thing about developers, too, right? If you ask a developer what's going to be in the game, they're going to tell you what they want to put in the game. And what they think they can get into the game. But that's why they have PR handlers. So the PR handlers can, then you can't say that. Then you can't say that. Then you can't say that. Yeah. So before we go, we're going to go ahead and harvest my fucking crops here. Because my turnip seed should be pretty much done. And anyway, so that's where we're at, right? That's where we're at on the, in terms of my personal situation with my relationship to games and gaming in general. Yeah. Like, I'll always play a game for free. Will I buy it? I don't know. Is it worth money? Or is it just good enough to be played for free? Because, I mean, I could do your total dick. I mean, yeah, I got a tiny channel. Sure, it's tiny. But I can go, well, you're getting paid in exposure. Which is as worthless as it always has been, yeah? I don't need exposure, dude. I need money. I'll be happy to give you money, dude. Does your game work? Yes, all the time? Well, there's your answer then. Will you give me money? Yes. When it works? Well, yeah. Well, indeed. Well-a-day, well-indeed. This game, though, outside those couple of little janky things, it's worth it. It's absolutely worth it. If they ever get around to fixing that, if they ever get around to making spears work like they should, if they ever make a spears work like they should, you'll see me whipping out my credit card. Yeah. The instant I can swing above and below my feet, and the instant arrows start coming out of my dick, I will absolutely spend $20 in this game. Just for the value I've gotten from playing it so far. Yeah. Just from that alone. Absolutely. So that's where we're at. Yeah. You're here for the tangents. Well, you definitely got your money's worth today, Coogan. I don't know where the fuck that came from. But anyway, with that, I'm gonna do this again, guys. I know this is weird, because then whatever, when you have a companion that spends a third of your life with you, you gotta honor him. I miss you, Mr. Beans. You're a good boy. With that, I want to thank y'all for stopping by, sharing your Sunday with me for the up to 3 hours and a little bit of change that you did, if you did. If you had a good time today, I'd appreciate you clicking that like button. Feed that YouTube algorithm, get some more people in here so I can say you're getting more exposure on your titles on my crappy little channel. If you're new to the channel, and this is the first thing you're seeing, and you like this kind of thing, click subscribe for more of, well, this kind of thing. I stream something on Sunday starting at noon central, currently Valheim, but next week I guarantee you it's going to be 76, because we're going to talk about their new method of whatever. Apparently they're changing the scoreboard to some kind of ticket page. I really haven't looked at it, whatever the fuck. But we're going to roll a scrub, and we're going to go ahead and go through the lower game again to see if anything's changed, and we're going to check out that their new system. And I'm going to figure out if I like it or not. Mr. Beans, indeed. Mr. Beans is very, very missed. He is the best boy. My take on that, yeah. From what I've read, Marty, I don't think I'm going to hate it as much as everybody else does. But that's because of other dynamics, which we will definitely talk about. As always and as ever, I want to thank y'all for watching, and I will see you in the next one. Take care, y'all.